Sports Network programming begins in 18 minutes. Programming begins in 17 minutes. Husker Sports Network programming begins in 16 minutes. Husker Sports Network programming begins in 15 minutes. Husker Sports Network programming begins in 14 minutes. Husker Sports Network programming begins in 13 minutes. Husker Sports Network programming begins in 12 minutes. Husker Sports Network programming begins in 11 minutes. Husker Sports Network programming begins in 10 minutes. Husker Sports Network programming begins in 9 minutes. Husker Sports Network programming begins in 8 minutes.
Tonight, a special presentation of Husker Sports, the best of Nebraska football's greatest games.
Kaya under center, Johnson behind him, turn, hand it off to Duke Johnson, and he bikes forward for a first down. Ball pops out, it's picked up by Nebraska, this is a fumble, it's picked up by Josh Mitchell, 30, 20, Mitchell, 10, 5, touchdown Nebraska!
All the big plays, all the big names. With the voice of the Huskers, Greg Sharp.
Four down linemen for Nebraska to snap back. Little delay, handoff to Johnson. It's blown up. Malik Collins drills him at the 19-yard line. It's a loss of three. It's fourth down.
And color analyst Matt Davison.
What a hit. Malik Collins shoots through the line of scrimmage and drilled Johnson.
Now, here's the host of Husker Sports' greatest games, Josh Hilkeman.
Welcome in. It's a Greatest Games edition of Sports Nightly. As we've settled into a different world this week on the Husker Sports Network, we've been implementing some different features on the show, some new and some old. Greatest Games is a feature we usually save for the middle of summer or occasionally over the holidays, but we've decided to bring it back for the upcoming weeks as we all try to live in a world without live sports. So be sure to tune in every Friday from 6 to 9 for Greatest Games. And you can also join us on Facebook for a live chat of each game replay. Tonight, we're replaying Nebraska and Miami from September 20th, 2014 at Memorial Stadium in Lincoln. It was the first meeting between the two teams since the 2001 National Championship game at the Rose Bowl in California. Nebraska entered the 2014 matchup with a 3-0 record, while the Hurricanes came in with a 2-1 mark. The build-up to the game was tremendous. Members from the 1994 National Championship team were in town to be honored at the game, and in fact, that's where we'll start our coverage. In the meantime, head over to Facebook and join Jeremiah Sirles as he hosts a live chat with former Huskers Ameer, Abdullah, Kenny Bell, and Josh Mitchell. As you do that, we'll send you back to September 20th, 2014 with Greg Sharp and Matt Davison at Memorial Stadium moments before kickoff between Nebraska and Miami.
The 1994 Huskers are here tonight. They're going to be coming out shortly. They, I'm sure, will be part of the Tunnel Walk. The Tunnel Walk originated in 1994 before a UCLA game is where the birth of the Tunnel Walk came about. And that was a team that had grit, that had fight, that had overcome a lot of obstacles, Matt, and go win a road game to win a national title, and they did it all.
You know, it's probably as you look at the history of Nebraska football, and there's people listening that know, have at least seen many more games than I have. They've been around the program a lot longer than I have. But you'd have a hard time finding a team that defined Nebraska, the people of the state of Nebraska, more than that 1994 team. Like you said, the grit, the hard work, the perseverance after the 93 disappointment against Florida State to come back and say, we're not going to be denied next year. And they came back in 94 and had to go to Miami, play them in their own stadium, and try to win a national title. And that's not easy. They got it done.
The Tunnel Walk is starting now, and it's beginning with Coach Osborne's halftime speech that year.
It has finally happened for Nebraska. In another marvelous and memorable contest at the Orange Bowl, they've finally done it. Nebraska coach Tom Osborne has brought an unbeaten, untied, number one ranked team to this game. He has borne all of it through the years with a dignified, self-effacing manner, and now his great coaching resume is complete. While those of us in network television aren't supposed to root, I think we can allow ourselves a chance to smile and some words of appreciation for a man who has studiously avoided self-aggrandizement in an age all too devoted to style over substance. As we leave you now, try to imagine all across the Nebraska Plains, this first national title in a generation is a wonderful way to start this new year and a wonderful and crowning moment in the career of Tom Osborne. Nebraska, national champs, 24-17.
We're coming out from underneath the Husker North Stadium, Milt Teteper, members of that 94 team. This is pretty cool.
Greg, this is one of the best tunnel walks you're ever going to see in your life. Charlie McBride, Milt Teteper, the coaching staff from that 94 team, guys that were with Tom Osborne through disappointment, through victory, and they are leading this football team out on the red carpet towards Memorial Stadium, where they're going to be welcomed by as big an ovation as you'll ever hear. Everybody in the Husker Nation pulling for Milt Teteper, whose health has not been good the last few months. He's in a wheelchair, and Ron Brown pushes him out onto Memorial Stadium, followed by the members of the 94 team who all have jackets on.
And they all have their cell phones out. They're all taking pictures as they come out, Matt.
They didn't have cell phones in 94.
This is absolutely an amazing sight inside Memorial Stadium. A tribute to a champion is what is taking place right now in front of 91,000.
You know, it's hard to ever second guess, but you don't know where this program would be without the guys that were on that 94 team and those coaches that made it happen in the mid-90s to take this program from already a prominent program to an historic program that's up there with the best of all time in the history of this game. But these guys made it happen.
And now time for the current edition for their tunnel walk as the 94 team is lining the tunnel to welcome them on the field. Marching their way toward that horseshoe to tap it on their way out. I don't know that I have witnessed this stadium like this before.
The anticipation for this game was unbelievable. I've had goosebumps four times in the last 3 minutes. I about started crying. This is an emotional night for Nebraska and for a lot of fans, Greg, that had a lot of pent-up frustration for Miami for decades. And we've beat them, and they've beat us. But this is an emotional rivalry, and for a lot of our fans, they remember the heartache many times going down to the Orange Bowl. Well, we have them in Memorial Stadium tonight. This place is ready for them.
And the Huskers have emerged from the northwest corner. We'll let you hear them run their way out through the tunnel, which includes the 94 national champions. Here they come. Gathering in the southwest corner, Al Golden in his traditional dress shirt tie. He's waiting for the noise to come down a little bit. Here come the Hurricanes out of the southwest tunnel. They have a pretty good group of fans that have made the trip up here to Lincoln tonight. But I can't wait to send it down to the middle of the field. Lane Grindle, we got goosebumps up here. You got to be rocking down there.
It is absolutely electric. It's been that way in this town all day long. But the 94 team coming out takes the cake. That was just some scene, seeing Milt Tenneper being brought out in a wheelchair by Ron Brown, carrying that AP National Championship trophy. And then the 94 team working the crowd as the Nebraska players were making their way down the tunnel as well. Showed just great camaraderie and what makes Nebraska such a special place. We're here at the middle of the field for the coin toss. Dennis Hennigan is our referee. The Huskers captains, the same as always, Ameer Abdullah, Josh Mitchell, Kenny Bell, Corey Cooper. Among the Canes captains is that fantastic wide receiver, Philip Dorsett, who had that record-setting day a week ago.
All right, here's heads, here's tails. What's your call? Tails is your call. Heads it is, you won the toss. Before you started the call.
So Miami made the call. They called tails. It was heads. Ameer Abdullah speaking for Nebraska says we will defer. So Nebraska will kick to start up this game. And the Huskers are going to kick towards the south end zone. So that means Miami will have the ball. Miami will have the ball down in the student section to start this game.
All right, thank you, Lane. Man, I got to admit, I'm glad we've had a minute or two to compose ourselves. That was emotional to watch all that.
Well, seeing Milt Tenneper is something that, for those of us that had a chance to play for him, is—it's hard to see.
Yeah.
Well, as a player, you try to get ready to play every game, and the players on our team or the other sideline in Miami, they might not know a lot about the history of this rivalry. Maybe they do, but I'll tell you, if you're not ready to play this one, then you're in the wrong sport. This is as good as it gets in college football, which is as good as it gets in America for sports in general. This is a big-time atmosphere. There's going to be some big collisions on this opening kickoff.
And this kickoff will be by Drew Brown. Remember, Mauro Bondi in a motorcycle accident 48 hours ago broke his clavicle. He's out for a while. So the true freshman, Drew Brown, who has kicked off three times already this year, two of them touchbacks, will tee it up for Nebraska. Dorsett and Colley. Deep Colley is really good back there. He had a TD a year ago against Savannah State. Huskers wearing those gorgeous scarlet and cream uniforms with that beautiful white helmet with the M on the side. The Canes, white tops, that rich green pants, their white helmet with that distinctive U on the side of the helmet. We are ready for football. Glad you joined us tonight on the Husker Sports Network Corp. You're listening to us at Huskers.com. Nebraska kicking from left to right as we view it. Brown with the approach and the boot. Hammers away. It's going to Coley. He's 8 yards deep. Goes to an E. Miami will start at their own 25-yard line. So now Nebraska will go after true freshman Brad Kaya. 6'4", 209 pounds, 60% completion to the first 3 weeks. Seven touchdowns, but he's been picked five times. Not a runner at all. He will be a pocket guy throughout the day, and you can expect Nebraska to dial up the heat.
Stopping the run is number one, and you can bet Miami's going to try to make that happen early in the game, see if they can get anything going on the ground to tick this crowd out of it. If they do go up top, Greg, look for him to take shots down the field at least four to five times tonight. I think you'll see them air it out, throw it as far as they can.
Huskers go their base set. Duke Johnson, the deep back. From the 25 for the Canes. Johnson nearly 300 yards rushing this year. Turn, fake handoff. Rolling it back is Kaya, looking over the middle. Pass is caught for a first down up to the 40-yard line by Malcolm Lewis. The sophomore makes his sixth catch of the year. Daniel Davey on the tackle, but a 15-yard pickup for the Canes who go play action in, on their first snap.
Yeah, good call there, knowing Nebraska's excited. Try to draw the linebackers up and run a deep dig, which they don't run many of those routes. A lot of slants and a lot of deep throws. Not a lot of those middle to intermediate routes, but they ran one there.
Nebraska goes to their dime package on first and 10. Kaya in the shotgun. Johnson to his right. Trips to the near side. Turn delay handoff to Johnson. Johnson gets by the Husker initial way. Picks up a first down. Cracks his way to the Nebraska 42-yard line. That's an 18-yard game. Cockrell and Cooper combined on the tackle. Josh Banderas got shoved off the play about 3 yards past the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, he had a chance. I mean, he had to come up and make that play. He got stiff-armed right in the face mask. Johnson's a great player. He's a lot like Abdullah. He'll make you miss, and he's got open field moves and speed.
Miami has it at the Nebraska 43. Five wides, empty backfield. Kaya looks right, throws right, passes caught in the flat. Slipping the tackle is Coley. He's racing downfield to the 30 and then spun down at the 27-yard line. That's a 16-yard gain. Randy Gregory knocks down the extremely electric Stacy Coley, who has seven career touchdowns for Miami.
Randy Gregory ran 50 yards on that play to make the tackle 20 yards downfield.
What a drive by Miami to start this game. A minute and a half in, they have it at the Husker 26. Kaya has looked sharp early. Duke Johnson in the backfield with him. Kaya will go shotgun. Two wideouts tight to the line of scrimmage. Kaya goes gun from the Husker 26. Kaya checking off. Play clock at three. Gets the shotgun snap. Looks right. Sets. Throws. Pass caught. Short gain. Oh, now close. Fighting his way for 9 yards is Malcolm Lewis. Josh Mitchell makes the Husker tackle. But, boy, it's been big play after big play in this opening drive of the Canes.
Nebraska brought a blitz off the left side with Kalu. And they ran a quick slant, a little hot route. When they see the blitz, run a quick slant into it, and they completed the pass.
Second one from the Husker 17 is Duke Johnson in the backfield with Kaya. Two wideouts each way. Kaya raises the leg on second one from the Nebraska 17. Now stepping up to the line of scrimmage to check off. And Nebraska matching the chess game. Kaya gets the shotgun snap. Looking right, holding, throws it out of bounds. It'll be third and one. It was intended for Braxton Berrios, the true freshman. Malik Collins with some heat up in the face of Kaya that time. Now sets up third and one.
Good job checking off there as a defense. Miami changed the play at the line of scrimmage. Nebraska changed the defensive coverage and really confused Kaya as he dropped back with the ball. Big third down.
Duke Johnson in the backfield with Kaya. Two wide outs to the near side, a wing to the near side. One wide out to the far side of the pattern for the Nebraska 17. Kaya gets the snap, hands it off to Johnson. He gets hit and fights forward for a first down.
You're listening to Sports Nightly. This is the Husker Sports Network.
Valley 365 is here, and the time is now to take your farming technology full circle. Valley 365 is the ultimate command center, the new single sign-on platform that brings together our tried and true technology and streamlines your entire operation. Combining the best features of AgSense, Valley Scheduling, Valley VRI, and Valley Insights, Valley 365 is the next level solution for connected crop management. Leverage your data, make the most of your time, and own your tomorrow. Contact your Valley dealer today.
Fill up. To get to work. To camp. To grandma's. To the movies. To the skate park. To try the world's best tacos. To watch the sunset at Mount Rushmore. To ride on a green fiberglass dinosaur. Fill up your life. From the greatest monuments to those little moments, Sinclair is proud to fuel America's journeys. Go farther for less with DinoCare, Sinclair's top-tier engine cleaning gasoline. Learn more at SinclairOil.com.
You always dreamed of owning your own farm. Now you're living your dream, and it's time to pick the tractor that makes it all come together. Massey Ferguson has reinvented what compact and utility tractors can be and redefined what they do, making them easier to operate, more comfortable to drive, more versatile than ever. Massey Ferguson gives Nebraska farmers the power and performance to win in the field.
Manzer Equipment Incorporated of Osmond on Highway 20, Osmond.
Shop Woodhouse Ford and experience the Woodhouse difference. Ford Truck Month is going on now. Lease a 2019 Ranger Super Crew 4x4 XLT for $279 a month for 36 months. 7,500 miles a year, first payment, dock fee, and $1,500 down payment due at signing. Security deposit waived, tax title license extra. Come and visit us at one of our three convenient locations in Blair, Omaha, or Plattsmouth. Built Ford proud. WACTTL Extra, lease for $279 per month, 36 months, 7,500 miles per year. First payment, dock fee, and $1,500 due at signing. Stock number T193631. Offer expires 03/31/2020. See dealer for details.
Making a quick trip to the store? You climb into the driver's seat. You start the car. The seatbelt indicator blinks and sounds. But you decide you don't need to use one. Think you are the only one that suffers if you don't wear your seatbelt? Think again, you're wrong. Family, friends, and coworkers suffer if you are killed or injured in a crash. Click it or ticket. Saving lives every day.
Make it click. NDOT Highway Safety Office. Fans Nebraska Athletics has a new official app. Stay up to date with score alerts, live stats, live audio, roster schedules, and more by downloading the official app of the Huskers. Presented by Nebraska Crossing Outlets. Create your custom experience and stay on top of everything related to game day. With the ability to purchase tickets and merchandise, access the Husker Light Show, and concessions information, this app has everything a Husker fan needs. Download it in the Apple or Google Play Stores today.
Nebraska baseball, from grit to glory, tells the story of Will Bolt, starting from his playing days to his early coaching career and his eventual return to Nebraska. From Grit to Glory features interviews with former Nebraska baseball coach Darren Erstad, ESPN college baseball analyst Kyle Peterson, as well as Bolt's former teammates Jeff Lisey and Dan Johnson. Listen to this edition of our Husker Sports Network Originals, presented by JTech Construction.
This is the Husker Sports Network from Learfield IMG College. You're listening to Sports Nightly.
The Husker Sports Network is always on the air on Facebook and Twitter. Like the Husker Sports page on Facebook and follow at Husker Sports on Twitter. You'll get exclusive up-to-the-minute coverage of your Huskers, including live football practice reports, previews of what you'll hear on Sports Nightly that night, instant reaction and analysis on Husker news, and Nebraska Athletics coverage that you can't see or hear anywhere else. Follow the Husker Sports Network on Twitter and like the Husker Sports Network on Facebook today.
For nearly 50 years, Nottle Companies has carried on a tradition of bringing great developments to Husker Nation. As a commercial real estate developer, property manager, and investment company, we believe the community is our client. Visit some of our latest projects in Omaha, like Heartwood Preserve in the Builders District or River's Edge in Council Bluffs. Don't forget to check out the Inner Rail Food Hall coming this fall to Exarban Village. For more information on our projects, visit nottlecompanies.com. Go Big Red!
Shop Woodhouse Chevy First in Missouri Valley, Iowa today and experience the Woodhouse difference. At Woodhouse, we make car buying simple and transparent. Take advantage of some of the best deals going on during Chevy Truck Month, like $11,000 off select Chevy Silverados. The Silverado is the perfect truck to get the job done. Find new roads and shop all of our inventory and offers at WoodhouseChevy.com. Or visit us at our dealership in Missouri Valley, Iowa today. This is Woodhouse. WEC TT Electric, $100,000 off in MSRP. MSRP $15,615. Stock number K200402 and K200388. Offer expires 3/31/2020. See dealer for details.
From the University of Nebraska-Lincoln, I'm journalism student Grace Fitzgibbon with Campus News. The cochlear implant program at UNL's Barclay Speech, Language, and Hearing Clinic is giving the gift of hearing. Spearheaded by Professor Josh Sevier, the program has completed more than a dozen cochlear implant activations over the past year. It's the first clinic to specialize in cochlear implants outside of the Omaha metro area, and Sevier plans to expand his efforts to reach patients in western Nebraska.
Chris Stapleton's All-American Roadshow. Saturday, October 17th, Pinnacle Bank Arena. With special guests, the Marcus King Band.
You wanna drink a water, got to go to the well.
And Yola.
Take a ride out in the country.
Tickets on sale now at Ticketmaster.com or the Ticketmaster app on your mobile device. Chris Stapleton's All-American Roadshow.
Fans, Nebraska Athletics has a new official app. Stay up to date with score alerts, live stats, live audio, rosters, schedules, and more by downloading the official app of the Huskers. Presented by Nebraska Crossing Outlets. Create your custom experience and stay on top of everything related to game day. With the ability to purchase tickets and merchandise, access the Husker Light Show, and concessions information, this app has everything a Husker fan needs. Download it in the Apple or Google Play Stores today.
The Sports Nightly Hotline is brought to you by Woodhouse Auto Family, bringing you more choices in brands, locations, and service. Experience the difference, purchase with confidence. This is Woodhouse. Welcome back to Greatest Games. I'm Josh Hilkeman. Tonight we're replaying the September 20th, 2014 matchup between Nebraska and Miami. A reminder to head over to Facebook and join our live discussion of the game there with host Jeremiah Sirles and a trio of Huskers who played in that game, Ameer Abdullah, Kenny Bell, and Josh Mitchell. At the end of the last segment, you heard Duke Johnson score for the Canes on a 2-yard touchdown run. We pick up the action with 10:26 left in the first quarter and Miami's ensuing kickoff.
Newby and Abdullah deep for Nebraska. Bagley kicking away. He kicks a low kick. It bounces and picked up by one of the Huskers, who then shovels it back to Ameer at the 20, and he gets stopped right there. I believe it was Janovich who scooped it up and then lateraled it back to Ameer, but pretty good kick coverage by Miami. Tackle made by Fentress at the 19-yard line. So the Huskers get the football for the first time of the game, down 7-0 at their own 19.
See if this offensive line can do some work tonight. Get Ameer some holes. You know, he had one big hole last week. Other than that, not much.
Two wideouts to the near side. Kenny Bell to the far side of the pattern. Pistol set. Abdullah behind Armstrong. Now he shifts to the shotgun. A wing to the far side. Turn. Zone read. Back to throw as Armstrong sets. Throws. Ball batted down at the line of scrimmage. Knocked down by Armbruster, who's had a terrific start to this year. The senior linebacker, Thurston Armbruster, knocked that ball down at second down and 10.
Tried to fake the zone read to Ameer Abdullah and finds Ethan Carter out in the flat. Good job getting his hands up there by Armbruster to knock it down.
Second and 10 for the 19. Two wideouts each way. Pistol set for the Huskers. Now shifting to the gun. Abdullah to the left of Tarmy Armstrong. Snap back. Hand it off to Ameer. He cuts to the outside. He's got a lane. 25, 30. Abdullah across the 35 up to the 36-yard line. That's a 17-yard gain. Tackle made by the corner, Gunter. And there's Abdullah getting loose for a nice gain on his first carry of the night.
Really good block on the edge there by Jordan Westerkamp on Armbruster.
Huskers go quickly. Shotgun look. Now movement on the left side is Alex Lewis.
False start. Offense number 71. 5-yard penalty. First down.
And that costs the Huskers 5 yards. Pistol set, now shifting to the gun. Trips to the far side for Nebraska. Armstrong gets it, looks wide receiver screen, throws it out the flat, pass is caught by Kenny Bell. Moving forward, gets back the 5 yards from the penalty. It'll be second down and 10. Tackle made by the safety, Deion Bush.
Got it out there quick to Kenny Bell. Had Westerkamp out there blocking for him, along with Gladney, who's out split to the left.
Second and nine, turn, zone read, give it off to Abdullah. Bounces into the outside of the 40, Ameer to the 43, and then ripped out of bounds there by the defensive end, Tyreek McCord. Ameer goes for 6 yards. It sets up third and three for the Nebraska 43.
Good cut there. There was nowhere to go, but Ameer made something out of nothing.
Trips to the near side, including Seatham Carter, one wide out to the far side. Abdullah right behind Armstrong. Shotgun look for Nebraska on third and three from the Husker 43. Zone read. Tommy keeps it himself. He's got a first down to midfield. Armstrong to the 45. Down to the 40-yard line. Tommy Armstrong running hard. Tackle made by Artie Burns. That goes for 17 yards.
Great job on the read there. Keeping it, bouncing it out to the outside. Tommy just had to make one man miss. Had Kenny Bell out there blocking for him.
Amani Cross in the game now. Trips to the near side from the 40. 8:20 to go. First quarter, 7-0. Miami with the lead. Tommy gets the shotgun snap. Back to throw. Looking, throwing deep downfield. Wide open. Kenny Bell makes a catch. 10-5. Touchdown, Nebraska.
Could see that play develop, Greg. Kenny Bell was lined up, trips to the right. He was the closest wide receiver to the formation. Ran right up the seam. They ran Jordan Westerkamp behind him on a crossing route. That held the man in the middle of the field. There was nobody behind him. A strike thrown by Tommy Armstrong for 6 points.
Kenny Bell's first touchdown catch of the year, and it's a big one for 40 yards. Here's Drew Brown to try to tie it. Snap down, kick is up, and the kick is good. Each of Kenny Bell's last 14 touchdowns, and that was his 16th of his career, have covered at least 20 yards, and he moves into a tie for third in school history and career touchdown receptions, tying Mo Purify. So the Huskers do answer right back to Miami and tie this one up at 7 apiece.
The Huskers strike back, a 40-yard touchdown pass from Armstrong to Bell. And we get you back to the action with Nebraska's kickoff.
Drew Brown's kickoff sailing toward the end zone. Coley gets it and goes to an E. 7-7 game, 8-12 to go, opening quarter. Both teams scored on the first time they touched the football. Johnson in the backfield along with Kaya. Two wideouts to the near side. Miami better hurry. There's 5 on the play clock. And they're going to have to burn a timeout or take a penalty. There's a penalty. Delay a game on Miami. Nice job, Canes.
That's well. Game, offense, 5-yard penalty, first down.
That's solid coaching being done on the near sideline. Make it first and 15. I mean, they were just flat lazy getting off the sideline.
Yeah, I don't know what took them so long to get out there. None of the coaches realized the play clock was running down, and nobody was asking for a timeout. They didn't even know. Now they're playing behind the chains.
Kaya goes shotgun, two wideouts each way. Johnson to his right from the 20. Snap back. Kaya holding, looking. Throws over the middle, pass is caught. And with it is Johnson. He's got a first down on the 40, 45-yard line out of bounds there. Corey Cooper in pursuit. That is a 25-yard pickup by the Canes.
Well, it's a short crossing route. It's a tough route to defend. Josh Banderas was in man-to-man on the running back. That's a tough matchup there.
They'll actually give him a 26-yard gain of the 46, so they quickly overtake the penalty. Johnson stays in there. Wing to the near side. Walford is now in motion to the far side. Two wideouts that way. Stretch play to the right to Johnson. He bounces to the outside, gets hit, swarm, fights forward to the 49, a gain of 3. It'll be 2nd and 7. Vincent Valentine makes the tackle for Nebraska.
Pretty good pursuit there down the line of scrimmage. Randy Gregory did a good job of setting the edge there on the double team.
7:10 left, opening quarter, 7-7 game here in Lincoln tonight. Trips to the near side, one wide out to the far side. That's Lewis. Johnson of the backfield with Kaya. Kaya in the gun. Huskers with four down linemen. Kaya back to throw. Randy Gregory coming after Kaya. Gets his, he throws. Pass incomplete. It'll be third down. Great pressure up front by Randy Gregory. Also, Malik Collins was about to sandwich Kaya as well.
Well, Gregory just did the bull rush on this one. Comes off the right side, takes the left tackle, and shoves him right back into the face of Kaya. And as he's letting go of it, there's Malik Collins to hit him as well.
So now 3rd and 7, a chance to get off the field. Miami came into tonight only converting 21% of their third downs. And Nebraska is only allowing their opponents to convert 27%. Here's 3rd and long, 3rd and 7.
Randy Gregory now standing up in the middle of the line of scrimmage. Just 3 down linemen for Nebraska.
Kaya in the gun. Johnson to his right. Back to throw is Kaya. Looking, holding, throws over the middle of the field. The pass is caught for a first down at the 30-yard line by Barrios. Berrios holds on. He got mashed once he caught it at the 29 of Nebraska, 21-yard pickup.
Nebraska plays coverage there, just rushed three guys, had pretty good coverage, had bracket coverage at the in the slot there, but they were able to throw it right in between the two defenders.
Down to the Nebraska 28, first and 10 Miami, 6.5 left in the opening quarter. Kaya in the gun, man in motion from right to left, back to throw is Kaya, getting hit as he throws downfield. The pass is nearly intercepted by Santos. He has it. It's an INT for David Santos, his first career interception.
What a tough play by David Santos. They run a wheel route against him going down the left sideline. There was a lot of arm barring going on back and forth with the tight end. Santos makes an unbelievable catch at the 5-yard line.
A huge play on defense by Santos as he tightropes the sideline and comes down with the ball to stop the Miami drive. We'll step aside, and after the break, you'll hear Nebraska's drive with the game still tied at 7. That's next.
You're listening to Sports Nightly. This is the Husker Sports Network.
It's your month, America, because this is Ford Truck Month. Your month for great deals on legendary Ford trucks like F-150, Super Duty, and Ranger. Your month to drive Ford F-Series, America's best-selling trucks 43 years straight. Your month for big-time power, off-road capability, and turning heads around town. Your month to, well, you get the idea.
Based on 1977 through 2019 calendar year total sales.
Great deals, tough trucks. Oh, yeah, it's Ford Truck Month, all right.
You always dreamed of owning your own farm. Now you're living your dream, and it's time to pick the tractor that makes it all come together. Massey Ferguson has reinvented what compact and utility tractors can be and redefined what they do, making them easier to operate, more comfortable to drive, more versatile than ever. Massey Ferguson gives Nebraska farmers the power and performance to win in the field.
Butte Implement Company of Butte.
What's wrong?
Nina's throat is killing her.
Ugh. And of course, it's Sunday.
Why do these things always happen at the worst times?
For healthcare that's easy, even on Sunday morning, turn to Nebraska Medicine, where you'll find the extraordinary care you need, where and when you need it most. With offices in more than 20 locations, our leading primary care providers focus on managing your family's ongoing health, while our immediate care clinics provide quick care, even on nights, weekends, and holidays. So whether you need stitches on Saturday or a physical on Friday, we offer expert care close by and always in tune with your life.
Well, for Sunday morning, that was easy.
Yeah. Now, if I could just get that song out of my head.
Better health begins with Nebraska Medicine. To schedule an appointment or learn more, visit nebraskamed.com/primarycare. Nebraska Medicine.
There's no community like a Cenex community, and that's why every Cenex store is so proud to serve theirs by supporting local athletic teams, promoting the arts, and making sure each store is a place its neighbors can find what they need, catch up with their friends, and stay connected. It's also why we give back, helping to make the wonderful places we call home the best they can be. Your local Cenex doesn't just work in your town, it lives there. The store next door, powered locally at Cenex.
Valley 365 is here, and the time is now to take your farming technology full circle. Valley 365 is the ultimate command center, the new single sign-on platform that brings together our tried and true technology and streamlines your entire operation. Combining the best features of AgSense, Valley Scheduling, Valley VRI, and Valley Insights, Valley 365 is the next level solution for connected crop management. Leverage your data, make the most of your time, and own your tomorrow. Contact your Valley dealer today.
Fill up. To get to work. To camp. To grandma's. To the movies. To the skate park. To try the world's best tacos. To watch the sunset at Mount Rushmore. To ride on a green fiberglass dinosaur. Fill up your life. From the greatest monuments to those little moments, Sinclair is proud to fuel America's journeys. Go farther for less with DinoCare, Sinclair's top-tier engine cleaning gasoline. Learn more at SinclairOil.com.
Hey Husker Nation, this is former Pipeline member Brendan Stye here to tell you Bill Moose was right when he said,
Nebraska needs to get back to being Nebraska.
And you can help us get there. Go big and be a part of the future home of Nebraska football. This project will once again establish Nebraska as the standard for growth and commitment to student athletes, and we need your help to make it happen. Contact the Huskers Athletic Fund office or visit HuskersAthleticFund.com to find out how you can contribute. Go Big Red.
This is the Husker Sports Network from Learfield IMG College. You're listening to Sports Nightly.
Your journey starts now. Arrow Stage Lines is now accepting applications for CDL drivers across all locations. This is not just a driving job. This is an adventure. At Arrow Stage Lines, you get paid to experience scenic destinations, sporting events, historical landmarks, and so much more. Drive some of the latest pristine equipment on the road with superior safety ratings, excellent benefits, and so much more. Start your journey today at Arrow Stage Lines. Apply at drivearrow.com.
I always wanted to do this. The mess, the noise, it's gonna be awesome.
Babe, what are you talking about? And what's with the sledgehammer?
I'm gonna demo the bathroom.
We chose Bathfitter to do the remodel, remember?
So?
With Bathfitter, there's no demolition or mess. They custom make our new bath and can install it in as little as one day.
No demo?
No demo.
Bathfitter's been exceeding expectations for 35 years, and we've got over 2 million satisfied customers to prove it. Visit bathfitter.com to learn more and book your free in-home consultation.
For nearly 50 years, Nautil Companies has carried on a tradition of bringing great developments to Husker Nation. As a commercial real estate developer, property manager, and investment company, we believe the community is our client. Visit some of our latest projects in Omaha, like Heartwood Preserve in the Builders District, or River's Edge in Council Bluffs. Don't forget to check out the Inner Rail Food Hall, coming this fall to Exarban Village. For more information on our projects, visit nautilcompanies.com. Go Big Red!
What's wrong?
Nina's throat is killing her.
Ugh, and of course, it's Sunday.
Why do these things always happen at the worst times?
For healthcare that's easy, even on Sunday morning, turn to Nebraska Medicine, where you'll find the extraordinary care you need. Where and when you need it most. With offices in more than 20 locations, our leading primary care providers focus on managing your family's ongoing health, while our immediate care clinics provide quick care, even on nights, weekends, and holidays. So whether you need stitches on Saturday or a physical on Friday, we offer expert care close by and always in tune with your life.
Well, for Sunday morning, that was easy.
Yeah. Now, if I could just get that song out of my head.
Better health begins with Nebraska Medicine. To schedule an appointment or learn more, visit nebraskamed.com/primarycare. Nebraska Medicine.
Over 6 million Americans meet the criteria for gambling addiction, and many more are affected by gambling problems. Problem gambling is a serious condition. With help, problem gamblers can improve their lives. If you or someone you love has a gambling problem, call Choices Treatment Center at 402-476-2300 or the Nebraska Gamblers Assistance Program at 1-833-238-6837. Help is free, so call today.
Nebraska baseball from grit to glory tells the story of Will Bolts from his playing days to his return to Nebraska as head coach. Subscribe to Husker Sports Podcasts on any streaming service to listen to the newest Husker Sports original presented by JTech Construction. Welcome back to Greatest Games. I'm Josh Hilkeman. Tonight we're replaying the Huskers 2014 matchup with Miami. You can follow along with our live chat on Facebook with Jeremiah Sirles leading the discussion, along with Kenny Bell, Ameer Abdullah, and Josh Mitchell. When we left you, the Blackshirts had just come up with a huge play as David Santos intercepted a ball at the 5-yard line. We send you back to Memorial Stadium now with Greg Sharp and Matt Davison. 6:09 left in the first quarter, a 7-7 game, and the Huskers starting a drive at their own 5-yard line.
Armstrong under center. Abdullah the one back behind him, and he's in the end zone to line up here from the 5. Wing to the near side, 2 wide out to the far side. Turn, hand off Abdullah. He's got a hole, dives up to the 9-yard line, gains 4, and he just barely got tripped up as Denzel Perryman, the outstanding middle linebacker for Miami, just does get him down, and that could have been a big gain for Ameer. Turn, hand off to Ameer, trying to push his way. He's across the 10, fights to about the 13-yard line, another 4-yard gain. Now Matt, a big third down, coming up 3rd and 2. Tackle made by Olsen Pierre, one of the D tackles for the Canes.
Boy, is Ameer hitting the hole strong tonight. Just full bore right down the A-gap.
Big 3rd down and 2 coming up. Abdullah behind Armstrong. Sam Cotton, a wing to the far side. 2 wide outs to the far side. Tommy will now go shotgun from the Nebraska 13. After the turnover, the INT from David Santos. Kenny Bell's in motion. They fake the handoff. Give it to Ameer. He's upended. He did not get it. He got a yard, needed 2. Thurston Armbrister knocked him down. So Nebraska, three runs, gets 9 yards, not enough to move the chains. And here comes Sam Fultz and the punting unit. Collie deep. This guy's dangerous. Had a punt return against Duke for a touchdown a year ago. Fultz, good high booming kick. Not real deep, but a high kick. Fair catch called for and made at the Miami 36-yard line. Fultz did a tremendous job. 50 yards, no return. And so Miami will take over at their own 36-yard line. Gus Edwards in the backfield this time. Duke Johnson not on the field. Well, they're both out there. Johnson's lined up as a wideout to the near side. Duke Johnson's a terrific football player. Looks a lot like Ameer. 5'9", 206. Both wear the number 8.
Looks like Miami has trips to the left side of the formation and one wideout to the right. Nebraska appears to be in base defense with three linebackers out there. Could be a mismatch somewhere.
Kai in the gun. Now Johnson in motion. Now they go two wideouts each way. Snap back. Looking to get it out to Johnson. He makes a catch, slips a tackle, 40-yard line, and knocked out of bounds by Corey Cooper, but that's close to a first down, an 8-yard pickup. It'll be second down and 2 from the 45.
That's a play you call from the sideline. You run a guy across the formation. Nobody went along with him, so Johnson gets out to the flat. That tells Miami Nebraska's probably not in man-to-man defense. They flip it out to him and have a blocker in front of him.
Second and 2. Two wideouts to the near side. One back, it's Johnson. Kaya's under center this time. Turn, hand it off to Johnson, trying to bounce to the outside. Huskers cover it, bringing down. It's a loss of a play. David Santos fires up, a loss of a yard, sets up 3rd and 3.
What a play by Santos on the edge. That's not an easy guy to make an open field tackle like that against. Johnson had a little bit of space to work, and Santos came up on the edge and just drilled him.
So 3rd and 3, Huskers shuffling personnel. They'll bring their dime package in. From the 44 of Miami, 3rd and 3. Johnson in the backfield with Kaya. All the wideouts are tight to the formation. Two on each side. Now in motion is Berrios. Three to the far side now. Snap back. Kaya looks, throws, pass bobbled, incomplete. Off the mitts of Berrios. It's a 3 and out for the Husker defense. Miami's going to be sending it back.
Well, he dropped it. I mean, it would have been a first down. Cockrell was there to make the play, but I think he would have had the first down by the length of the football, but he dropped it. Miami will be forced to punt.
DeMornay Pearsonell back at the Nebraska 10. Here is Justin Fogle, averaging 46 yards a kick. Gets a snap, a low kick. DeMornay Pearsonell grabs it, gets hit, knocked down immediately at the 19-yard line. He got hit right on the thigh after the 37-yard punt, but a good job for him to come up and get it, because if that bounces, that thing was going to head toward the end zone. It might have been down inside the 5.
It's a dangerous play, but a good play by Pearsonell to come up and make that catch.
1st and 10, Big Red at their own 19. Abdullah behind Armstrong, trips to the far side, Kenny Bell to the near side. Now go shotgun to the Huskers. Tommy checking off, 5 on the play clock. 4, 3, 2, claps his hands, gets the ball. Takes the handoff, keeps it himself. Armstrong across the 20 to the 21. A late flag comes out. Only a gain of about a yard and a half. Tackle is made by the big defensive tackle, Hurtello, who is a Scottsdale Community College
holding
transfer.
Offense number 71, 10-yard penalty, first down.
So Alex Lewis gets hit with his second penalty of the opening quarter. That'll back Nebraska.
Huskers barely got that play off. They run back to the left side after faking the zone read. And as Alex Lewis's man was trying to get away from him, held on just a second too long.
Two wide out stacked each way. In the shotgun is Armstrong. Turns, hands it off to Ameer. Ameer gets up to the 15 and knocked down there. Gain of about 5. Set up 2nd down and 14 as Miami quickly closes that hole on the Huskers.
Well, that should have been no gain, but Ameer made a guy look silly in the alley, made him miss, and was able to get 6 out of it.
Ameer with that carry goes to 4th all-time in the school rushing chart. Just went by Roy Helu with that carry. 2 wideouts to the far side, 1 to the near side. Shotgun look on 2nd and 14. Tommy back to throw, holding, looking, throws downfield, pass is caught. First down, Nebraska at the 30-yard line. Pulled in by Alonzo Moore, and Nebraska has wiped out that holding penalty. They have a first down out near the 30-yard line. Tackle made by Jamal Carter.
That's a good catch by Alonzo Moore. That ball was on an absolute line. He was able to go up and get it, and they're going to give him the first down by about a yard.
Nebraska might have got a favorable spot on that. 1st and 10 at the 29-yard line. 1.5 left on the quarter, 7-7 game. Pistol set, Abdullah right behind Armstrong. 2 wideouts to the near side, 1 to the far side. Stretch play left to Abdullah, racing hard around the edge. Ameer gets Collared at the 38-yard line. That's about a 7-yard gain by Ameer off the left side. Maybe an 8. Well, no, it's a 10-yard gain. They put it clear up to the 40-yard line.
Ameer Abdullah runs hard every game we come out here. I don't know if I've seen him run harder than this. I mean, he is a man possessed so far in this first quarter.
Huskers go pistol set from the 40-yard line. Now goes shotgun. Carter, a wing to the near side. They throw it out in a flat to Westerkamp. Makes a catch. He's got room. He's to midfield. He's got a first down. Westerkamp out of bounds to the Miami 46-yard line. A 14-yard gain on Armstrong's flip to Jordan Westerkamp. Two wideouts to the far side. Turn. Fake the handoff. Tommy keeps it himself. Fumbles the football. It's loose and picked up by Anthony Ciccolo. And Miami gets a turnover as Armstrong fumbles at the Miami 44-yard line.
Tommy just got stood up there. He had some room to operate. He made a cut. And the defender guessed right, put his helmet right on the football, and it went straight to the ground. Miami jumped on it.
So turnovers even at one apiece. Miami gets it back at their own 44-yard line. Under center is Kaya Johnson behind him. Wing to the near side. Wing now moving to the far side of the pattern. Wide receivers left and right. More of a power look for Miami. Back to throw is Kaya. Pump fakes. Sets throws. Pass caught by Wolford, the tight end at the 40 of Nebraska. That is a pickup of 16 yards of the first down for the Canes. Zaire Anderson makes the Husker tackle.
Well, the coverage was good. It was Zaire Anderson was in the coverage and looked like Cooper was over the top. But again, they were able to fit it in between the two defenders like we saw on the last drive.
So now Miami down to the Nebraska 40. They do not have to snap this if they don't want to before the end of the quarter. Kaya's in the shotgun, and that will end the first quarter.
One quarter in the books. We're almost through the first hour of the show tonight. When we come back, we'll start the second quarter and wrap up hour one. Stay with us.
You're listening to Sports Nightly. This is the Husker Sports Network.
Valley 365 is here, and the time is now to take your farming technology full circle. Valley 365 is the ultimate command center, the new single sign-on platform that brings together our tried and true technology and streamlines your entire operation. Combining the best features of AgSense, Valley Scheduling, Valley VRI, and Valley Insights, Valley 365 is the next level solution for connected crop management. Leverage your data, make the most of your time, and own your tomorrow. Contact your Valley dealer today.
Why choose between the technology you need and the seed company you prefer? With Rob Seco, you don't have to. Our independence lets us bring you the trait technology you need, like the Enlist E3 and the Liberty Link GT27 systems, AgriSure Duracade, AgriSure Viptera, AgriSure Artesian, and more. So you have the independence to plant what you want. The technology you need from the people you trust. Rob Seco. Visit RobSeco.com to find a representative near you.
Hey, Husker Nation, this is former Pipeline member Brendan Stye here to tell you Bill Moose was right when he said,
Nebraska needs to get back to being Nebraska.
And you can help us get there. Go big and be a part of the future home of Nebraska football. This project will once again establish Nebraska as the standard for growth and commitment to student athletes, and we need your help to make it happen. Contact the Huskers Athletic Fund office or visit HuskersAthleticFund.com to find out how you can contribute. Go Big Red.
It's your month, America, because this is Ford Truck Month. Your month for great deals on legendary Ford trucks like F-150, Super Duty, and Ranger. Your month to drive Ford F-Series, America's best-selling trucks 43 years straight. Your month for big-time power, off-road capability, and turning heads around town. Your month to, well, you get the idea.
Based on 1977 through 2019 calendar year total sales.
Great deals. Tough trucks. Oh, yeah. It's Ford Truck Month, all right.
So how you doing?
Well, you know how I was running out of options for my heart?
Of course.
I finally found the solution at Nebraska Medicine.
When it comes to your heart, don't take chances. Start with Nebraska Medicine, where leading heart and vascular specialists offer the most innovative advances, like a nationally renowned heart failure program and Nebraska's only heart transplant program, with volumes ranking among the highest in the Midwest. We also offer cardiac clinical trials, as well as genetic testing and counseling to identify problems before they affect your health in the future. All just a short drive from home.
So, everything's okay now?
Well, after my heart procedure, my shortness of breath is gone, my energy's back, I feel great.
Oh, that's good to hear.
For the state's most comprehensive heart and vascular care, visit NebraskaMed.com/heart. Nebraska Medicine. Serious medicine. Extraordinary care.
Fill up. To get to work. To camp. To grandma's. To the movies. To the skate park. To try the world's best tacos. To watch the sunset at Mount Rushmore. to ride on a green fiberglass dinosaur. Fill up your life. From the greatest monuments to those little moments, Sinclair is proud to fuel America's journeys. Go farther for less with DinoCare, Sinclair's top-tier engine cleaning gasoline. Learn more at SinclairOil.com.
This is the Husker Sports Network from Learfield IMG College. You're listening to Sports Nightly.
When I hired Bathfitter, I got a new bathtub that I love. It's made with the same quality materials they used in luxury hotels. It's great. Even my mom thinks so.
I love your new tub, sweetie.
Trouble is, when she visits, she thinks she's staying in a five-star hotel.
Could I get fresh towels?
Yes, Mom. Mom.
From luxury hotels to homeowners, Bathfitter exceeds expectations. Transform your bathroom in as little as one day. Visit bathfitter.com to learn more and book your free in-home consultation.
Your journey starts now. Arrow Stage Lines is now accepting applications for CDL drivers across all locations. This is not just a driving job. This is an adventure. At Arrow Stage Lines, you get paid to experience scenic destinations, sporting events, historical landmarks, and so much more. Drive some of the latest pristine equipment on the road with superior safety ratings, excellent benefits, and so much more. Start your journey today at Arrow Stage Lines. Apply at drivearrow.com.
The Sports Nightly Hotline is brought to you by Woodhouse Auto Family, bringing you more choices in brands, locations, and service. Experience the difference. Purchase with confidence. This is Woodhouse. Greatest Games rolls along on a Friday night. I'm Josh Hilkeman. We're through one quarter of the September 20th, 2014 matchup between Nebraska and Miami. Head to Facebook and join our live discussion featuring Josh Mitchell, Kenny Bell, and Ameer Abdullah. We'll start the second quarter now. The Hurricanes have the ball in Nebraska territory. Here again are Greg Sharp and Matt Davison.
First and 10, Miami at the Nebraska 39. Kaya in the gun. Johnson to his left. Two wideouts, far side, a wing to the near side. A turn. Give it off to Johnson. He gets hit in the hole and knocked back. Vincent Valentine brings him down after a gain of a yard. Josh Banderas also in there. It'll be second down and nine.
That was a good job by Banderas. Took a good angle there to make that play.
So Huskers put Miami off schedule a little bit now with second and nine. Huskers go back to their base defense here for the second down play. Two wideouts to the left of the pattern. Wing to the near side. Kaya is going to go shotgun with Johnson. Huskers line up with their four down linemen. Now Walford, the tight end, comes to the near boundary. Kaya sets, throws downfield. Johnson wide open on a wheel route, breaks a tackle 20, 15, cuts back to the 10, knocked out at the 6-yard line. So Brad Kaya hits the Huskers, and there's more activity back up field between John Feliciano and I think Randy Gregory got into it behind the line of scrimmage, and now the official, I think, is going to have Eric Flowers, the tackle, come out because he lost his helmet. That play, though, hits the Huskers down inside the 10 for 32 yards.
Another missed tackle about the 25-yard line. Allowed an extra 15 to 20 yards at the end of that play. The coverage was not there. I don't know where the breakdown was, but he was wide open. And I don't know how Johnson gets wide open.
First and goal with six. Two wideouts to the far side. Kaya in the shotgun. Gus Edwards to the right. Snap back. Back to throw as Kaya gets in as he throws. Pass is caught. That is a touchdown, Walford. Clive Walford, the tight end. He's really a good player. Third touchdown catch of the year. Miami back in front, 13-7.
It's a good throw under pressure. David Santos buried Kaya as he threw the ball, but a good route in traffic. And Nate Gary gave him a good pop once he caught the ball, but it was too late, 14-7 after the extra point.
Here's Michael Badgley to try to add one more on the board. Badgley, a true freshman, snapped down. His kick is up, and the kick is good. And Miami's reclaimed the lead at 14-7.
Miami retakes the lead on the touchdown pass from Kaya to Walford, 14-7 Hurricanes. That'll do it for Hour 1 of tonight's show. You're listening to Greatest Games. And we'll continue the second quarter of Nebraska versus Miami at the start of the next hour. You won't want to miss it.
Husker Sports Network from Learfield IMG College. You're listening to Sports Nightly.
So how you doing?
Well, you know how I was running out of options for my heart?
Of course.
I finally found the solution at Nebraska Medicine.
When it comes to your heart, don't take chances. Start with Nebraska Medicine, where leading heart and vascular specialists offer the most innovative advances, like a nationally renowned heart failure program and Nebraska's only heart transplant program, with volumes ranking among the highest in the Midwest. We also offer cardiac clinical trials, as well as genetic testing and counseling to identify problems before they affect your health in the future. All just a short drive from home.
So, everything's okay now?
Well, after my heart procedure, my shortness of breath is gone, my energy's back, I feel great.
Oh, that's good to hear.
For the state's most comprehensive heart and vascular care, visit NebraskaMed.com/heart. Nebraska Medicine. Serious medicine, extraordinary care.
I always wanted to do this. The mess, the noise, it's gonna be awesome.
Babe, what are you talking about? And what's with the sledgehammer?
I'm gonna demo the bathroom.
We chose BathFitter to do the remodel, remember?
So?
With BathFitter, there's no demolition or mess. They custom make our new bath and can install it in as little as one day.
No demo?
No demo.
BathFitter's been exceeding expectations for 35 years, and we've got over 2 million satisfied customers to prove it. Visit BathFitter.com to learn more and book your free in-home consultation.
For nearly 50 years, Nottle Companies has carried on a tradition of bringing great developments to Husker Nation. As a commercial real estate developer, property manager, and investment company, we believe the community is our client. Visit some of our latest projects in Omaha, like Heartwood Preserve in the Builders District, or River's Edge in Council Bluffs. Don't forget to check out the Inner Rail Food Hall, coming this fall to Exarban Village. For more information on our projects, visit NottleCompanies.com. Go Big Red!
Tonight, a special presentation of Husker Sports, the best of Nebraska football's greatest games.
Kaya under center, Johnson behind him, turn, hand it off to Duke Johnson, and he fights forward for a first down. Ball pops out, it's picked up by Nebraska, this is a fumble, it's picked up by Josh Mitchell, 30, 20, Mitchell, 10, 5, touchdown Nebraska!
All the big plays, all the big names. With the voice of the Huskers, Greg Sharp.
Four down linemen for Nebraska to snap back. Little delay, handoff to Johnson. It's blown up. Malik Collins drills him at the 19-yard line. It's a loss of three. It's fourth down.
And color analyst Matt Davison.
What a hit. Malik Collins shoots through the line of scrimmage and drill Johnson.
Now, here's the host of Husker Sports' greatest games, Josh Hilkeman.
Hour two of the show starts right now. I am Josh Hilkeman, and this is Greatest Games. As I mentioned at the start of last hour, this will be something that we'll have for you on a weekly basis for the time being, as we all adjust to the absence of live sports. Our game tonight is Nebraska versus Miami on September 20th, 2014. The hype was amazing leading up to the game. Members of the Huskers' 1994 National Championship team were in the stadium, and the environment was electric. Last hour, you heard the first quarter with touchdowns from Duke Johnson of Miami and Kenny Bell's 40-yard touchdown reception. Right before we ended the last hour, Miami took the lead. Just over a minute into the second quarter on a TD pass from Brad Kaya to Clive Walford. Right now, be sure to head over to Facebook and check out our live chat of the game featuring Ameer Abdullah, Kenny Bell, and Josh Mitchell with Jeremiah Sirles leading the discussion. As you do that, we'll send you back to Memorial Stadium with Greg Sharp and Matt Davison.
Badgley to kick it off for Miami. Abdullah and Newby deep. Badgley does not have a great leg. This should be returnable for Nebraska. He hit a low liner, did Badgley his first kickoff of the game. The approach and the kick is heading towards Ameer Abdullah. Ameer right at the goal line. He's on the far boundary to the 10, coming to the middle of the field, 15, breaks a tackle, and then runs into a wall at the 20-yard line. So that's where Nebraska will have it at the 21. 21-yard return by Ameer. Well, Huskers down seven. Second time Nebraska is trailed by seven. Trips to the near side. A pistol set with Abdullah. Now to the left he goes in the shotgun. Back to Tommy. Zone read. Gives it off to Abdullah. He cuts back 25, 26-yard line. Again, a five, maybe 6 yards from here. It'll be second down and four. Tackle made by Jamal Carter, one of the safeties for Miami.
Nebraska will try to go quick here, make one substitution. Now you have Abdullah and Terrell Newby both in the backfield with Tommy.
Trips to the near side. No tight ends of the formation this time for Nebraska on second and four from the 27. Back to Armstrong. Keeps it himself, does Tommy. He's got a first down across the 30, up on the 32-yard line. A gain of about six. Tackle made by Umfamba, the junior defensive tackle, but the Huskers move the sticks.
Yeah, good job there by Tommy. On the zone read. Got a nice block right up the middle. Chongo Condolo.
First and 10, big red at their own 32. Early second quarter, 14-7, Miami with the lead. Two wideouts to the far side, a wing to the far side. Abdullah right behind Armstrong. Turn, straight handoff to Ameer. Ameer to the 35, bouncing to the outside, breaks a tackle, piece of the 40, and he's finally wrestled down after a 9-yard gain to the 42-yard line, brought down by Artie Burns. What a tough run by Ameer Abdullah here early in this game.
Man, is he running hard. There was nothing there, really. Should have been about a 3-yard gain, and he was able to get his pad level low, make a man miss, fight for 9 yards.
We told you earlier that Ameer went by Roy Helu. He just went by Eric Crouch. He's now the third all-time leading rusher in Nebraska. Second and one, maybe a chance to take a shot here at the 41-yard line. Trips to the near side, a wing to the far side. Amani Cross in the game. Kenny Bell in motion. Snap back. Puts it in the belly. Or Tommy keeps it himself. Breaks a tackle across the 45. He's got a first down at the 47-yard line. Somebody's top came off. It's Jake Cotton. He'll have to come out of the game. Darian Owens, true freshman linebacker, makes a tackle for the Miami Hurricanes.
First and 10, Nebraska ball to 47.
And Dylan Utter comes in to run, play the left guard spot for the snap. Tariq Allen on the field to the near side. Amani Cross stays in the game. First and 10, big red at their own 48. The wing is Sam Cotton. He's set to the near side. Man in motion, it's Kenny Bell. And they toss it to Kenny. Kenny's got a block out front. He's to the midfield mark and then gets, well, he's still on his feet, driving forward to the 46 of Miami. That is a gain of 7 yards for Kenny Bell, tackled by Armbrister and Kirby.
First time we've seen Nebraska give it to the motion man. Saw this a couple of times against Fresno. Got a good block out there from Amani Cross and a nice tough run there at the end to finish it for Kenny Bell.
Second and three for the Miami 46, 11:20 to go first half, 14-7 Hurricanes. Now you go Wildcat set with Ameer ready to get the snap. Bell in motion. Ameer keeps it. Bounces up the middle. He's to the 40. He's got a first down to the 39-yard line. He might have been a step away from going.
And he can't believe it. I think he stepped on somebody's foot. That's a wrinkle we haven't seen. The Wildcat run, Kenny Bell in motion, fake it to him, and Ameer keeps it. And he was about a step away from making it a big gain.
8-yard pickup. Huskers have it first and 10 at the 39-yard line of Miami. Ameer behind Tommy this time. Wide receivers left and right. Armstrong gets the snap. Puts it to Billy of Ameer down to the 35-yard line. As Nebraska really starting to hammer between the tackles, Matt, a 4-yard gain. Let's go down the lane.
Yeah, and that's exactly what you're seeing down here is just Nebraska getting off the ball much better than they have the last couple of weeks. This offensive line looks like they're on the same page. A lot of quick hitting, quick developing plays, and Nebraska's speed, I think, starting to get to this Miami defense a little bit, both in the pace of play and how many snaps they want to get off, but also Nebraska's speed really showing up at the skill positions.
Lane Hovey in the pattern this time. Trips to the near side. Tommy will have Amani Cross behind him. It's a shotgun look with Ethan Carter. Now Ameer Abdullah in motion. He lined up as a wideout. Tommy gives it off to Amani Cross. Not much. And a flag comes out. Might have a hold at the point of attack. It was Trent Harris and Corn Elder on the tackle for Miami. This one may cost Nebraska.
It's
holding. Offense number 65. 10-yard penalty. Second down.
Ryan Reeves, who's in there at the center for Nebraska this try. That'll back Nebraska up. You've got Reeves at the center. Chongo Condola, the right guard, and Givens Price at the right tackles. Nebraska rotating those offensive linemen here. Now they're off script, though, Matt. It'll be second down and 17 from the 46. Two wideouts to the near side. One to the far side. Ethan Carter, the wing to the near side, who now shift to the right of the formation. Amani Cross in the backfield. Terrell Newby lined up as well. Now we get a timeout by the Huskers. Armstrong will be in the backfield with Abdullah. Trips to the far side. Kenny Bell set to the near side. Turn. Hand off to Abdullah around the right side. A short gain down to the 40. Gets about six back. Sets up third and 11. Tackle made by Chicola along with Perryman, the middle linebacker. Perryman, the leading tackler on this team, all ACC a year ago.
Yeah, that penalty was a killer. Now you're in a third and long.
Third and 11 from the 40 for Nebraska. Huskers just 1-for-2 on third down so far. Shotgun look for Armstrong. Two wideouts to the near side. Back to throw is Tommy. Holding, looking, sets, throws, back shoulder throw, pass, caught. First down for the Huskers. Kenny Bell came back to get it at the 23-yard line.
And both officials have their hat off. Kenny Bell was out of bounds. The question is, did the defender ride him out of bounds? Kenny was definitely out of bounds, came back in to make the catch. We'll see how the official calls this. They're going to pick it up and go.
Big time throw and catch. Huskers have it at the 23-yard line. Little zone read, handoff to Abdullah. He's to the 20, 15-yard line. Ameer fighting for about 9 yards that time. It'll be second down and one. Second and one from the 15. Shotgun look, trips to the far side. Snap back. Zone read. Tommy keeps it himself. Tommy to the 15, to the 10. He's got a first down. Armstrong down to the 6-yard line. Brought down by Artie Burns. It's first and goal. Big red at the 6.
That was a good read there. They crash down on Abdullah. The end goes with Abdullah. Armstrong keeps it himself and goes off the right side. Now you got to jam it in the end zone.
12th play of the drive for the 6. Pistol set. Abdullah behind Armstrong. Now they go straight. Shotgun trips to the near side. One to the far side. Snap back. Zone read. Hand it off. Tommy keeps it himself inside the 5, down to the 3. It'll be second and goal from the 3. Perryman, the president, they call him, made the tackle for Miami.
Now let this offensive line work. I don't know that you just line it up with two tight ends and a fullback and try to jam it at him right now. I like giving Ameer Abdullah some room to work.
Shotgun look again. Abdullah to the right of Armstrong. Lane Hovey in motion. Snap back. Tommy looking to throw. Holding. Throws out the flat. Hovey makes a catch and gets drilled. Ball pops out. It's an incomplete pass. And now it's third and goal from the 3-yard line.
The timing was off on that play from the start. The snap was late. Tommy, there was nowhere to go. He throws it late into the flat, which is a way to get your guy blown up. And Hovey, poor guy, there's nothing he could do. He took a big shot there.
From Artie Burns. Now third and goal from the 3 for Nebraska. I'm with you. I would have just kept pounding right up the middle on this team. Two wideouts to the near side. Bell to the far side. Pistol set. 3 in the play clock. Tommy gets the shotgun snap. Back to throw. Throws it out in flat to Ameer. Makes a catch at the 5. Skip Holmes, the man. He's in. Touchdown, Nebraska.
Get it to your best player in space. Tommy Armstrong got it to him. Only one man had a chance to make that tackle. It was Ari Burns. And Ameer made him miss and was able to scamper in just on the right side by the pylon.
Huskers a point away from tying this game up. Drew Brown to try to make it a 14-14 game with 7:10 to go. That was a drive a lot of Husker fans wanted to see. Time-consuming, a big play drive. They get it done.
And the big play was the third down conversion to Kenny Bell on a 3rd and 11 where he's able to get pushed out of bounds, come back in. Tommy trusted him that he was going to get back in position to make the play. Kenny comes down with it. And that was a whole lot of Ameer Abdullah on that drive as well.
14 plays, 79-yard drive, 6:35 off the clock for Nebraska to tie this game up at 14.
The Huskers even the game once again on the short pass from Armstrong to Abdullah, making it 14-all. 7 minutes to go in the first half. You're listening to Greatest Games, and we're back after the break with Nebraska's kickoff.
You're listening to Sports Nightly. This is the Husker Sports Network.
Shop Woodhouse Buick GMC first and experience the difference today. Now offering up to $10,000 off MSRP on the 2020 GMC Sierra 1500 Crew Cab SLT 4x4. Our indoor showroom provides a clean and climate-controlled shopping experience. Visit us in-store today or online anytime at WoodhouseBuickGMC.com. This is Woodhouse Buick GMC. We are professional grade. Offer expires 3/31/2020. Stock number V200551C. Dealer for details.
Fill up to get to work, to camp, to grandma's, to the movies, to the skate park, to try the world's best tacos, to watch the sunset at Mount Rushmore, to ride on a green fiberglass dinosaur. Fill up your life. From the greatest monuments to those little moments, Sinclair is proud to fuel America's journeys. Go farther for less with DinoCare, Sinclair's top-tier engine cleaning gasoline. Learn more at SinclairOil.com.
There's a lot to be said for independence. With independence comes choice, from what you plant to the processes you apply to maximize performance. With Rob Seco, you work with the fastest growing independent seed company and the latest genetics and traits available. So you never have to choose between the seed company you prefer and the technology you need. Exercise your independence with Rob Seco. Visit RobSeco.com to find a representative near you.
You knew the risks when you decided to drive drunk. There could be a crash. People could get hurt or killed. But that didn't stop you, did it? You knew you could get arrested. You could incur huge legal expenses. And you could possibly even lose your job. You were well aware of the consequences of driving drunk. But one thing's for sure. You were wrong when you said it was no big deal. Drive sober or get pulled over.
Brought to you by the NDOT Highway Safety Office.
Why switch to U.S. Cellular? Because when you switch, you get a free all-new Samsung Galaxy S20 5G with never-before-seen features like the revolutionary Space Zoom camera, all on a faster network. Switch today and get a free Samsung Galaxy S20 5G. Turn-in required. That's not just smart, it's fair. U.S. Cellular. Choose fair.
New smartphone service plan, new line porting, credit approval, qualified trading, qualified smartphone purchase, and device protection plus required, and comes via monthly bill credit on a 30-month RIC. Taxes, fees, and terms apply. 5G not available in all areas. 5G available in parts of Iowa and Wisconsin in 2020. See associate for details.
This is the Husker Sports Network from Learfield IMG College. You're listening to Sports Nightly.
When I hired Bathfitter, I got a new bathtub that I love. It's made with the same quality materials they used in luxury hotels. It's great. Even my mom thinks so.
I love your new tub, sweetie.
Trouble is, when she visits, she thinks she's staying in a 5-star hotel.
Could I get fresh towels?
Yes, Mom. Mom.
From luxury hotels to homeowners, Bathfitter exceeds expectations. Transform your bathroom in as little as one day. Visit bathfitter.com to learn more and book your free in-home consultation.
For this, there's no choice. I have to go to Nebraska Medicine.
But Dad, there's way closer hospitals.
I know, but for cancer, you can't take any chances.
You're right.
All cancer care is not created equal. The Fred and Pamela Buffett Cancer Center at Nebraska Medicine offers greater access to the most promising clinical trials, breakthrough research, and an entire team of specialists focused on your type of cancer. It's also the state's only NCI-designated cancer center, a designation that signifies scientific leadership and the most advanced care.
Those doctors really know their stuff.
I know.
It feels really good to have a plan that's designed just for me, you know?
Yeah, it does.
Where you begin your cancer journey matters, and with 3 cancer centers, Nebraska Medicine's leading cancer care is just a short drive from home. Visit NebraskaMed.com/cancer. Nebraska Medicine. Serious medicine, extraordinary care.
For nearly 50 years, Nottle Companies has carried on a tradition of bringing great developments to Husker Nation. As a commercial real estate developer, property manager, and investment company, we believe the community is our client. Visit some of our latest projects in Omaha, like Heartwood Preserve in the Builders District or River's Edge in Council Bluffs. Don't forget to check out the Inner Rail Food Hall, coming this fall to Exarban Village. For more information on our projects, visit nottlecompanies.com. Go Big Red!
Your journey starts now. Arrow Stage Lines is now accepting applications for CDL drivers across all locations. This is not just a driving job. This is an adventure. At Arrow Stage Lines, you get paid to experience scenic destinations, sporting events, historical landmarks, and so much more. Drive some of the latest pristine equipment on the road with superior safety ratings, excellent benefits, and so much more. Start your journey today at Arrow Stage Lines. Apply at drivearrow.com.
The UFC is back in Lincoln, Nebraska on Saturday, April 25th for UFC Fight Night. In the main event, it's a light heavyweight showdown between two former title challengers, Anthony Lionheart Smith and Glover Teixeira. Plus, Ovin St. Preux tries to end the undefeated streak of Shamil Gamzatov. Live at Pinnacle Bank Arena. Tickets on sale now at Ticketmaster.com.
The Sports Nightly Hotline is brought to you by Woodhouse Auto Family, bringing you more choices in brands, locations, and service. Experience the difference. Purchase with confidence. This is Woodhouse. We're back with the greatest games, and I'm Josh Hilkeman. Tonight we're listening to Nebraska versus Miami from September 20th, 2014. And a reminder to head to Facebook and join our live discussion of the game there with host Jeremiah Sirles and a trio of Huskers who played in that game, Ameer Abdullah, Josh Mitchell, and Kenny Bell. Before the break, you heard Nebraska even the game up at 14 apiece on a 3-yard pass from Tommy Armstrong to Ameer Abdullah. We get you back to the action with the Huskers kickoff, 7:10 to go in the first half.
Drew Brown will kick it off. Again, Mauro Bondi broke his clavicle the other night riding a motorcycle around Lincoln. He'll be out for a while. So it's going to be Drew Brown doing all the kicking for Nebraska for the foreseeable future. Drew's kick, Coley at the goal line. It's coming out. He's to the 10. 15, look out, bounces off one tackler, Huskers grab him, throw him down at the 23-yard line, good tackle made by Jonathan Rose, good kick coverage by Nebraska.
Jonathan Rose made a good play there. If he doesn't make it, he's out in the open field with a lot of room to go.
Nebraska's got their nickel set to start this possession. Duke Johnson in the backfield along with Brad Kaya. Kaya's been good early, 11 of 15, did throw a pick, David Santos had that. So Roach in there for Banderas this time. Crowd really revving it up. Kaya in the shotgun. Back to throw. Looking over the field. Whistles blow. Flags come out. It might have been delay a game on. It is another delay a game on Miami.
Delay game.
Even happen on the beginning of two different possessions, they get a delay of game penalty. Lane, what are you seeing?
But you know, you can really criticize obviously the sideline for these, but also Kaya has absolutely no clue how much time's on the clock when they're breaking huddle. That could be a big thing as this game goes along. If the Huskers defense can settle in and this crowd gets more and more into it, Kaya's going to have to get more aware of the other things as he tries to manage this game.
Huskers go to their dime package. Is Joshua Kalu in there? Huskers send a blitz. Duke Johnson runs right into it, breaks a tackle, gets across the 21, and then Randy Gregory throws him down at the 22-yard line. That's a gain of about 4 on the play. It'll set up now 2nd and 11 from the 22-yard line. Nathan Geary came off the edge hard.
Looked like Nate Geary was going to be able to make the play right at the line of scrimmage. But another missed tackle. We've seen a bunch of them already in this half.
2nd and 11. Duke Johnson's got to tie his shoe. Kaya in the gun.
He's the best player we've seen this year.
He is. Walford to tight end in motion. Two wideouts to the far side. One of their side. Kaya rolls the pocket to the far side. Looks, sets, throws, passed it. Dropped. Nearly picked and then nearly caught for a catch. It rolled away from Lewis, the wideout, but I thought Byerson Cockrell was going to grab that for a pick for Nebraska. It's now 3rd and 11.
I think Miami's Lewis thought Cockrell was going to pick it too, and that's why it hit him in the chest and he dropped it.
So 3rd and 11. Chance for a 3 and out. Huskers stay with their dime package. Johnson in the backfield with Kaya. Huskers go with 3 down linemen. Randy Gregory standing up. Kaya lowers his shoulder. Al Golden wants a timeout. Miami 2 of 3 on third downs. Third and 11 here for the 21. Huskers do have the dime package on the field. Two wideouts each way. Tight to the formation. Kaya in the shotgun with Duke Johnson to his left. This crowd is really roaring. Kaya gets the shotgun snap, holds, looks, throws downfield, has a man out there. The pass is incomplete. Kaya threw it down the middle seam. The wideout stayed outside the hash mark, so it sails incomplete. It was intended for Philip Dorsett. Huskers had pretty good coverage downfield, and so it's a three and out for the defense. Well,
brought a little pressure, one extra man, and I think that could have been a pick by Nate Garrett if he'd have found the football, but he was running towards the wide receiver, and the ball was way offline by about 15 yards.
All right, here's Fogle to punt. Pearson L at the Nebraska 38. This might be returnable for Pearson L. Snap is back. Shank to kick. Low kick. Pearson L makes a catch at the Nebraska 38. Gets upfield. He's to the 40. Down the sideline, 45. Steps out of bounds at the 48-yard line. It's a 40-yard punt and then a 10-yard return. Huskers will have great field position with 6:01 to go in the half.
He's hitting yards again. Looked like he was going to get tackled with no return at all, and he was able to get 10 or 12 yards out of that.
Shotgun look, Abdullah to the left of Armstrong. Two wideouts to the far side, one. Kenny Bell to the near side. Ethan Carter, the wing to the far side. Snap back, zone read. Ameer's got it. Slips to the 50, into Miami territory, down to the 46-yard line. That's a quick hitter for six. Tackle made by Pierre, one of the D tackles. But Nebraska again staying between the tackles, running the football. Ameer now approaching 100 yards in this first half. And how about Tommy Armstrong's numbers? 7 of 9 for 101 through the air.
And two touchdowns.
Second down and four from the Miami 46. Wide receivers left and right. Huskers go double tight ends this time. Stay in the pistol. Snap back. Stretch play right side Abdullah. He splashes through. 40, 35, 30. Ameer inside the 30 down to the 27-yard line. He hit that hole like a whirlwind that time and shoots down there for a pickup on the play of 20 yards.
And Nebraska is doing some work up front right now. Sterup does a good job. Mowdy on the right side with great blocks. Kenny Bell rode his man down the sideline.
Huskers have it at the 28. Imani Cross now in there at the I-back spot. Ameer over 100 yards rushing for the third time this season. In the first half, he's done that. Turn. Hand off to Imani right side. Imani gets to the 25. He has a big-time collision that fights forward for about 7 yards to the 21. He and Darian Owens, a true freshman, really collided, but Imani got the better end of that deal.
Boy, you could hear that all the way up here, and they're on the far side at the 20-yard line. That was a big collision, and Imani got 3 or 4 yards after it.
Good, tough run by Imani Cross. It's second down and three. 4.5 left in the half. 14-14 tie. Second down and three for the 21. Trips to the near side. Shotgun look with Abdullah to the right of Armstrong. Kenny Bell to the far side. They hand it right off to Ameer. Little reverse to Pearson L. He's got a blocker in front. Pearson L can't break the tackle. It's no gain as he gets it back to the 21. Good play by Corn Elder, a corner who stayed home, and he was the only guy out there to bring down Pearson L.
Needed one block. Needed one block. He didn't get it. Tommy missed, and Sterup was out there, and he just didn't have the speed to make that block.
So now third and three for the 21. 3:40 left in the half. Huskers go Wildcat again with Abdullah ready to take the snap. In motion comes DeMornay Pearsonell. Ameer keeps it himself. Ameer bounces inside the 20 for a first down on the 15-yard line. So the Huskers bottled the block of Janovich that time. Then Ameer Abdullah, tackled by Deion Bush. That goes for 5 yards on a Husker first down. They're back in the Case IH red zone.
I don't know if they want Ameer throwing it out of this set, but it's sure been good snapping it to him, just letting him go.
Ameer has now passed Johnny Rogers for the school record and career all-purpose yards after that carry. I formation this time. Armstrong under center. Wide receivers left and right. Janovich the fullback. Hand it off to Ameer. He picks his way inside the 15. Still on his feet now to the 10. 6-yard gain by Ameer Abdullah. Pierre and McCord make the tackle for Miami. And the Huskers are total power right now against this Hurricane defense. And Miami is really starting to tank on that defensive front.
Well, it's power football, and right now the offensive line is saying you don't want to line up against us. And Ameer, even when it doesn't look like there's much there at all, he's getting 5-6 a carry.
This will remind Kane fans of the 94 fourth quarter, the way the Huskers are pounding away right now. Second down and four from the 10. Shotgun looks. Armstrong turns. Gives it off to Ameer. Not much. Down to the 10 and stop there. It'll be third down. Huskers 4 of 5 on third downs. Third and four here.
Might see Nebraska use a timeout.
So Nebraska will have one left. A minute 41 to go in the half. 14-14 tie. Nebraska looking at third and four from the Miami 10. Pistol set. Abdullah behind Armstrong. Trips to the near side. And there's movement up front. Miami jumped. Miami jumped early. That's five on the Canes. It'll be on the tackle Hurtado, who jumped early. The officials are talking about it. It looked pretty obvious to us up here that it was Hurtado who jumped early.
And Ameer Abdullah just let the crowd know that it's going against Miami.
Let's get it from the official word here.
Offside defense, five-yard penalty results in the first down.
And that'll give the Huskers a new set of downs on the five-yard line. So now Nebraska first and goal from the five. A minute 41 to go in the half. Each team with one timeout left. We're tied at 14. High formation. Abdullah dots the I. Armstrong turns. Option to the near side. Pitch out to Abdullah. Slides a tackle. Comes back the other way. Ameer trying to get to the outside. Gets back to the line of scrimmage. Wow, he did all that for no gain, but it could have been a loss of four or five. Perryman, the middle linebacker, finally knocked him down.
Man, he's an electric player. But just not good execution on the option there. Tommy was 3 or 4 yards deep by the time he pitched it, and Ameer was 7 yards behind the line when he caught it.
Second and goal from the five. Monty Cross in the game now. Two wideouts to the near side. Bell to the far side. A wing to the far side. Armstrong with a minute to go now and a half. Gets the snap. Follows Cross. Still on his feet inside the five, down to the three. It'll be third and goal at the three. Another Husker loses his helmet. Tyreek McCord makes a tackle. It was Ethan Carter that loses his helmet. Now third and goal from the three.
Boy, that play was just blown up from the start. Lucky to get two out of it.
Third and goal. Ball at the four for Nebraska. Inside the last 40 seconds now, 45 seconds of this first half. Moore and Westerkamp to the near side. Bell to the far side. From the four. Armstrong claps his hands, now looks to the sideline. Play clock at 15, game clock at 32. Huskers with one timeout left. Tommy checking off, tells Ameer what it is. Now we're at 25 seconds left in the half. Snap back, Armstrong gonna quarterback draw. He's to the 3-2 yard line and stop at the two. Maybe the one, no, it'll be at the two. And now Nebraska will call their final timeout. So here's Drew Brown, in essence, an extra point. He's right in the middle of the field. It's ball inside the 10. Out of the hold of Sam Fultz. This will be the final play of the half. Snap down. Brown's kick is up. And the kick is good. And Nebraska on the final play of the half takes the lead 17-14.
And that does it for the first half of play. Nebraska grabbing the lead 17-14 right before intermission on a Drew Brown field goal. We'll step aside for a few minutes and have the start of the second half right after this.
You're listening to Sports Nightly. This is the Husker Sports Network.
And we're back to the Ask the Diamond Coaches with Don and Rick Heyman.
Hey, coaches, what's the best way to propose?
The best proposals always start with the best ring, son.
So before you plan that bungee jump proposal, make sure your ring is right and it comes in the right box.
What matters most is the look on her face when the magical box appears.
You can skydive onto the field with smoking shoes, rookie, but if the ring doesn't come from the right place in the right box, you might as well keep on smoking and sailing.
All of her friends say, go to Sauter Heyman.
Sauter Heyman, official jeweler of Husker Athletics.
Fill up. To get to work. To camp. To grandma's. To the movies. To the skate park. To try the world's best tacos. To watch the sunset at Mount Rushmore. To ride on a green fiberglass dinosaur. Fill up your life. From the greatest monuments to those little moments, Sinclair is proud to fuel America's journeys. Go farther for less with DinoCare, Sinclair's top-tier engine cleaning gasoline. Learn more at SinclairOil.com.
Why choose between the technology you need and the seed company you prefer? With Rob Seco, you don't have to. Our independence lets us bring you the trait technology you need, like the Enlist E3 and the Liberty Link GT27 systems, AgriSure Duracade, AgriSure Viptera, AgriSure Artesian, and more. So you have the independence to plant what you want. The technology you need from the people you trust. Rob Seco. Visit RobSeco.com to find a representative near you.
For expert tire and automotive service at the best prices in town, count on locally owned and family owned Jensen Tire and Auto. Jensen will service your vehicle right and have you in and out in no time. Check out Jensen's latest deals at JensenTireAndAuto.com.
For the best tire prices guaranteed, get to Jensen Tire and Auto. Find a lower locally advertised price? Jensen will match it even after your purchase. The best tire price plus the best installation package in town. Guaranteed at Jensen Tire and Auto. Stop by or click on JensenTireAndAuto.com for details.
It's your month, America, because this is Ford Truck Month. Your month for great deals on legendary Ford trucks like F-150, Super Duty, and Ranger. Your month to drive Ford F-Series, America's best-selling trucks 43 years straight. Your month for big-time power, off-road capability, and turning heads around town. Your month to, well, you get the idea.
based on 1977 through 2019 calendar year total sales.
Great deals, tough trucks.
Oh yeah,
it's Ford Truck Month, all right.
Making a quick trip to the store? You climb into the driver's seat. You start the car. The seatbelt indicator blinks and sounds. But you decide you don't need to use one. Think you are the only one that suffers if you don't wear your seatbelt? Think again, you're wrong. Family, friends, and coworkers suffer if you are killed or injured in a crash. Click it or ticket. Saving lives every day.
Make it click. NDOT Highway Safety Office. This is the Husker Sports Network from Learfield IMG College. You're listening to Sports Nightly.
Over 6 million Americans meet the criteria for gambling addiction, and many more are affected by gambling problems. Problem gambling is a serious condition. With help, problem gamblers can improve their lives. If you or someone you love has a gambling problem, call Choices Treatment Center at 402-476-2300 or the Nebraska Gamblers Assistance Program at 1-833-238-6837. Help is free, so call today.
I always wanted to do this. The mess, the noise, it's gonna be awesome.
Babe, what are you talking about? And what's with the sledgehammer?
I'm going to demo the bathroom.
We chose BathFitter to do the remodel, remember?
So?
With BathFitter, there's no demolition or mess. They custom make our new bath and can install it in as little as one day.
No demo?
No demo.
BathFitter's been exceeding expectations for 35 years, and we've got over 2 million satisfied customers to prove it. Visit BathFitter.com to learn more and book your free in-home consultation.
Your journey starts now. Arrow Stage Lines is now accepting applications for CDL drivers across all locations. This is not just a driving job. This is an adventure. At Arrow Stage Lines, you get paid to experience scenic destinations, sporting events, historical landmarks, and so much more. Drive some of the latest pristine equipment on the road with superior safety ratings, excellent benefits, and so much more. Start your journey today at Arrow Stage Lines. Apply at drivearrow.com.
Hey, how's Marie?
Surprisingly well. We got her to Nebraska Medicine right away, and they removed the clot causing her stroke within minutes.
Minutes? Really?
Whether it's something serious or if you simply want to feel your best, start with the Nebraska Medicine Health Network. This is where world-leading specialists offer leading-edge services you won't find anywhere else in the state. Like Nebraska's only comprehensive stroke center and CAR T-cell therapy, the latest cancer breakthrough. We also offer innovative clinical trials and perform the most research in Nebraska. It all adds up to the state's most comprehensive care. So you have every advantage possible, close to home.
So she's all good? No problems from the stroke?
Oh yeah, perfectly fine. I mean, you can't even tell that she just went through something really serious.
Wow, amazing.
To schedule an appointment today, visit NebraskaMed.com. Nebraska Medicine. Serious medicine, extraordinary care.
For nearly 50 years, Nottle Companies has carried on a tradition of bringing great developments to Husker Nation. As a commercial real estate developer, property manager, and investment company, we believe the community is our client. Visit some of our latest projects in Omaha, like Heartwood Preserve in the Builders District or River's Edge in Council Bluffs. Don't forget to check out the Inner Rail Food Hall coming this fall to Exarban Village. For more information on our projects, visit NottleCompanies.com. Go Big Red!
Welcome back to Greatest Games. I'm Josh Hilkeman. We're replaying Nebraska and Miami from September 20th, 2014 tonight. You can follow along with our live chat on Facebook. Jeremiah Sirles leading the discussion along with Kenny Bell, Ameer Abdullah, and Josh Mitchell. Right now we're at the half and the Huskers have a 17-14 lead. Let's get you back to the action now with Miami's kickoff.
Huskers will have it to begin the second half. 17-14, Big Red with the lead. Huskers had the only time Nebraska led in this game was on the final play of the half. Here's Badgley's kick sailing towards Ameer. He's a couple of yards deep in the end zone. He's going to go to a knee. Nebraska will bring it out to the 25-yard line. So the Huskers will start here up 17-14, trying to run through non-conference perfect at 4-0. Huskers last 11 snaps of the first half, all runs. Shotgun look, Abdullah to the right of Tommy. Wing to the far side, turn, gives it off to Ameer. He's to the 30, cracks into the safety, fights his way for about 8 yards on first down. Perryman and Bush finally bring him down, but there's a quick hitter for eight more for Abdullah, who's now nearing 130 in the game.
Boy, the offensive line has just done a good job. The left side there, Alex Lewis with a great block on the edge. I'll tell you that Nebraska's O-line didn't like Ameer getting a little extra shove at the end of that play.
Shotgun again. Wing to the near side. Turn. Tommy gives it up. Fumble. And Ameer dives back on it at the 32. A loss of a yard. Now third and three coming up. Bad exchange that time between Armstrong and Abdullah, but Ameer able to pounce on it.
Well, good thing he's as quick as he is. That was just, as you said, a bad exchange. I don't know. As much as they run zone read, it just looked like the ball was never in there.
So third and three coming up for the Huskers at their own 32, opening seconds of the third quarter. Two wide receivers stacked to the near side. Now Kenny Bell in motion. Now you'll have trips on the far side. Snap back to Armstrong. Rolling right, looking, set, throws, pass, caught. First down. Just across the 35, pulled in by Alonzo Moore, who was in traffic. Tommy threw him a bullet for 4 yards on a Husker first down.
That's not an easy catch. It's not an easy throw. As you said, a lot of traffic over there. Just enough to get the first down.
Whew. Shotgun look again. Two wide receivers to the near side, one to the far side, and a wing to the far side. Snap back to Armstrong. Fakes it, gives it, keeps it himself as Tommy. He's across the 40 to the 41, a gain of five on first down. Burns and Perryman make the tackle for Miami.
Tommy's done a good job keeping it enough times tonight to really keep Miami a little bit honest, at least, in that zone read.
Second and five, trips to the near side. Shotgun look, handoff to Ameer. He's got a first down, 45, 50, to the 45, down to the Miami 42-yard line. Ameer Abdullah cracks off a big one that time for 17 yards.
He hits the hole so quick, and when he's in the open field, he's going to make somebody miss. And again, a good job up front. Looked like Jake Cotton had a great block, rode his man across the hole.
Huskers have it at the 42 of the Canes. 2 minutes into the third quarter. Huskers 17, Miami 14. Two wideouts to the near side. Amani Cross on the backfield. Tommy hands it off to Amani, who bangs his way inside the 40 to the 39. A 3 yard pickup. Tackle made by Pertello, the junior college transfer defensive tackle for Miami. It's second down and seven. And Nebraska just keeps pounding away at Miami. That defense is going to be gassed by the fourth quarter.
And I think they should continue to do that. They have not proven they can stop the run. Nebraska with 186 yards on the ground already.
Shotgun look, cross to the right of Armstrong. Tommy sets, throws downfield, incomplete. Being held is Ethan Carter. That is a pass interference on Thurston Armbruster. That'll be a new first down for Nebraska Lane.
I'm not sure that wasn't a designed running play. Ethan Carter was actually blocking Burns, and the contact is going to benefit Nebraska here.
Pass interference, defense number 34. The ball will be placed at the spot of the foul. First down.
Fourth penalty of the game on Miami. First and 10, big red at the 32 of the Canes. 12-10 left third quarter, Nebraska 17, Miami 14. Shotgun look, a wing to the near side, two wideouts to the far side, Kenny Bell to the near side. In motion now comes Terrell Newby. Fake the handoff, Tommy keeps it himself, 30, 25, 20. Armstrong down to the 17-yard line. Darian Owens makes a tackle on Tommy Armstrong. That goes for 15 yards. First and 10, Huskers of the 17. Pistol look. Hand off to Ameer, right side. He stretches. He gets down to the 16, only a gain of about a yard. It'll be second down and nine. Armbruster makes the tackle for Miami as they sub a couple more defensive tackles in there. They are really trying to get some fresh bodies on the field.
And Nebraska countering that by going pretty quick here again in this series.
Two wideouts each way on second and nine for the big red at the 16 of Miami. Opening drive of the third quarter. Nebraska trying to add their three-point lead. Pistol set. Now goes shotgun to the Huskers. Armstrong gets the snap. Fakes the handoff. Looks left. Throws left. Pass caught. Sliding catch by Alonzo Moore at the 8-yard line. It's a yard short of the first down. Nebraska a third and one at the Miami 8. And Alonzo Moore's having his best game as a Husker here tonight.
Yes, he is. Three catches now. Miami's saying that was incomplete, but it looked to me like he caught it. And he's just about a yard short.
Now, whistles blow. They may take another look at this. We are going to have
a ruling on the prior play was a completed pass. The play is under further review. The ruling on the field stands.
All right, so third and one at the 8. 10:44 to go third quarter. Nebraska 17, Miami 14. Huskers trying to get a two-score lead. They can punch this in here for 7 points. Abdullah in the backfield with Armstrong. A wing, Sam Cotton to the near side. Two wide receivers stacked to the far side. Now Nebraska goes shotgun. Turn. Give it off to Ameer. He's got a first down on the 6-yard line. Went off that left tackle. Dallas Crawford, a former running back, now a safety for Miami, makes the tackle. But now Nebraska with a new set of downs at the 6, first and goal.
He hit the hole hard there on the left side, Greg. He took a big shot. That was a big-time collision.
Here's the 11th play of the drive. Wide receivers left and right. Double tight end set. Pistol look. Armstrong gets the snap. Stretch play left to Abdullah. Cuts in for 5. Bangs his way. Touchdown, Nebraska!
Great blocks on the left side. Alex Lewis took his man to the goal line. Ameer made one cut. Great pad
level. He took a shot about the 3-yard line, but was able to dive over the goal line and give Nebraska a 2-score lead. What a drive to start the third quarter.
Ameer over 150 now in the game. That is his 24th career rushing touchdown. And the Huskers with an emphatic start to this third quarter with a nice drive. Here's Drew Brown. Point after try is up, and it is good. And Nebraska does have a 10-point lead at 24-14. That was impressive.
Abdullah extends the Huskers' lead to 10 with that touchdown run. 24-14 Nebraska with just over 10 minutes left in the third quarter. We'll get you back to the action right after the break.
You're listening to Sports Nightly. This is the Husker Sports Network.
Why switch to U.S. Cellular? Because when you switch, you get a free all-new Samsung Galaxy S25G with never-before-seen features like the revolutionary Space Zoom camera, all on a faster network. Switch today and get a free Samsung Galaxy S25G. Turn-in required. That's not just smart. It's fair. U.S. Cellular. Choose fair.
New smartphone service plan, new line porting, credit approval, qualified trading, qualified smartphone purchase and device protection plus required, and comes via monthly bill credit on a 30-month RIC. Taxes, fees, and terms apply. 5G not available in all areas. 5G available in parts of Iowa and Wisconsin in 2020. See associate for details.
Fans, Nebraska Athletics has a new official app. Stay up to date with score alerts, live stats, live audio, rosters, schedules, and more by downloading the official app of the Huskers. Presented by Nebraska Crossing Outlets. Create your custom experience and stay on top of everything related to game day. With the ability to purchase tickets and merchandise, access the Husker Light Show, and concessions information, this app has everything a Husker fan needs. Download it in the Apple or Google Play Stores today.
Fill up to get to work, to camp, to grandma's, to the movies, to the skate park, to try the world's best tacos, to watch the sunset at Mount Rushmore, to ride on a green fiberglass dinosaur. Fill up your life. From the greatest monuments to those little moments, Sinclair is proud to fuel America's journeys. Go farther for less with DinoCare, Sinclair's top-tier engine cleaning gasoline. Learn more at sinclairoil.com.
It's your month, America, because this is Ford Truck Month. Your month for great deals on legendary Ford trucks like F-150, Super Duty, and Ranger. Your month to drive Ford F-Series, America's best-selling trucks 43 years straight. Your month for big-time power, off-road capability, and turning heads around town. Your month to, well, you get the idea.
Based on 1977 through 2019 calendar year total sales.
Great deals, tough trucks. Oh, yeah, it's Ford Truck Month, all right.
You knew the risks when you decided to drive drunk. There could be a crash. People could get hurt or killed. But that didn't stop you, did it? You knew you could get arrested. You could incur huge legal expenses. And you could possibly even lose your job. You were well aware of the consequences of driving drunk. But one thing's for sure. You were wrong when you said it was no big deal. Drive sober or get pulled over.
Brought to you by the NDOT Highway Safety Office. This is the Husker Sports Network from Learfield IMG College. You're listening to Sports Nightly.
Our team, our time, tells the story of the 2009-2010 Nebraska women's basketball season as the Huskers went undefeated, took home the Big 12 Championship Trophy, and secured the number one seed in the NCAA tournament, making them the best team in school history. Subscribe to Husker Sports Podcast on any podcast streaming service to listen to the newest Husker Sports Original Podcast, presented by J-Tech Construction, the official exterior experts of the Huskers.
When I hired Bathfitter, I got a new bathtub that I love. It's made with the same quality materials they used in luxury hotels. It's great. Even my mom thinks so.
I love your new tub, sweetie.
Trouble is, when she visits, she thinks she's staying in a 5-star hotel.
Could I get fresh towels?
Yes, Mom. Mom.
From luxury hotels to homeowners, Bathfitter exceeds expectations. Transform your bathroom in as little as one day. Visit bathfitter.com to learn more and book your free in-home consultation.
The Sports Nightly Hotline is brought to you by Woodhouse Auto Family, bringing you more choices in brands, locations, and service. Experience the difference. Purchase with confidence. This is Woodhouse. We continue along with our greatest game show here at the end of Hour 2 as we're replaying Nebraska versus Miami from 2014. Head to Facebook now and join our live discussion featuring Ameer Abdullah, Kenny Bell, and Josh Mitchell. We ended our last segment after Abdullah's 6-yard run gave Nebraska a 10-point cushion at 24-14. That's right where we pick it up. 10 minutes to go in the third quarter with the Huskers on top by 10 points.
Drew Bramwell kicking away. Dorsett and Colley deep. Brown with the approach and the kick. This one might be returnable. It is calling at the goal line. He's to the 10, 15, 20, 24-yard line. Gets knocked down at the 24. Brought down by Jonathan Rose. Also, Joey Felici, the Millard South product, in on that tackle as well. And now the defense, which has not been out there in about an hour, really. The 20-minute halftime, the long time in the first half. It's been a long time since this defense has been out on the field. And Roach stays in at middle linebacker.
Nebraska's run 49 plays from scrimmage to just 24 for Miami.
Kaya will have Duke Johnson in the backfield with him. Duke Johnson running the football in this game, only 28 yards. Kaya's been impressive, though. Lewis in motion. They turn. Play action fake. Back to throw as Kaya has time. Throws downfield. The pass is incomplete. Pretty good coverage by Nate Gary. Covering up Berrios that time. It'll be second down and 10.
He had a lot of time to throw that ball. That's a tough angle for a safety to cover a guy on a deep crossing route. But Nate Gary found him and was in his hip pocket. Great job, Nate Gary.
Second and 10 from the 24. Huskers shuffle personnel in. They will drop out of their nickel and go to the dime as Joshua Kalu comes in. Four wideouts, two each way. Johnson in the backfield with Kaya, who's in the shotgun. Snap back, handed off to Duke Johnson. He gets to the 25, gets about 7 yards to the 31, brought down by Vincent Valentine. Sets up third down and three. A wing to the far side. Kaya in the shotgun, throws it out in a flat pass, is caught, and it's going to be close to a first, and he got it. He gets to the 35-yard line to Stacy Coley. And it's a 4-yard pickup. He only needed three, and so a new set of downs for Miami. Greg McMullen makes a tackle on the edge for Nebraska. Vincent Valentine coming out of the game. Kevin Maurice comes in for big old 98. And Nebraska comes back with their dime package here on first down. I think you may see a lot of dime here in the second half.
Yeah, there's a lot of speed out there. Nebraska has to match that speed.
Kai in the shotgun, two wideouts each way. Duke Johnson in the backfield. They hand it off to Johnson. Roach can't quite bring him down. Johnson stumbling forward, has 10 yards on a first down. Roach hit him, but couldn't quite bring him down, and Johnson gets 10 on the carry. First and 10, Miami at the 45. 8.5 left third quarter. Nebraska 24, Miami 14. Kaya in the gun, two wideouts each way. Johnson to his right. Kaya gets the snap, looking right. Sets, throws it to flat. Johnson makes a catch, and he gets hit and dropped. Knocked down to the flag. There's going to be a face mask on Josh Banderas. It was a loss of a yard, but that'll cost Nebraska some penalty. And it was almost a negative play, but a slip tackle was Cockrell, the one who couldn't quite
get it. Personal foul, face mask, defense number 52. 15-yard penalty, first down.
So Nebraska will get penalized 15. For Nebraska, that's their fourth penalty of the game, but that'll push the football into Husker territory at the 40-yard line. Empty backfield this time. Three wides to the far side, one at a near boundary for Miami. Huskers in their dime, looked out. You got Banderas in coverage to the near side. Kai gets it's a wide receiver screen out in the flat. Santos trying to get him down and does. About a half a yard gain. Good play by Santos on Coley. That is a big time mismatch speed-wise, but Santos got him to the ground.
Santos is playing the best right now of Nebraska's linebackers. That was a great job breaking down, not overrunning the play, and then getting him around the ankles and pulling him to the ground.
Second and 9 from the Nebraska 39. 7.5 left third quarter. Fast-paced game here tonight, 24-14. Huskers with the lead. Trips to the near side, one to the far boundary. Duke Johnson to the backfield with Kaya, who's in the shotgun. Snap back to Kaya. A delay handoff to Duke Johnson. He's got some room. 35-30. Johnson 25. Runs into Cooper, who brings him down to the 20-yard line. But that's a quick hitter for 19 yards and a hurricane first down.
And nobody left in the middle of the field there. Spread Nebraska out all over the place, and there was nobody left.
Gus Edwards in the backfield this time with Kaya. Two wideouts each way for the Hurricanes. Kaya gets the snap, looks left, throws left, wide receiver screen. Lewis makes a catch, gets it down to the 15-yard line, a gain of 5. Tackle made by David Santos, second and 5.
Gary got a piece of him. Santos brought him down. Nebraska's best defense has been their offense, just keeping Miami off the field. But they've been able to move it when they've had it.
Second and 5 from the Husker 15. Two wideouts to the near side, Lewis to the far side. Edwards in the backfield with Kaya. Kaya turns, gives it off to Edwards. He gets it to the 11. It'll be third and 1. It was Gregory and Banderas on the tackle. Third and 1 coming up. Gus Edwards stays in the backfield with Kaya. Two wideouts to the near side, one to the far side, and a wing to the near side. A turn, hand it off to Edwards. He spins, twists his way, and has a first down just inside the 10. Banderas knocked him down, but it'll be first and goal for Miami. We're inside of 6 minutes left third quarter. Huskers 24, Miami 14. Boy, you'd love to force them to try a field goal here. This will be the 11th play of this drive for the Canes.
Really fast third quarter. Both teams running the ball well.
Miami a little confused getting a play in here. Play clock at 13. They're just starting to line up now. Gus Edwards still in the game. Duke Johnson not out there. Two wideouts to the near side. The wing, the tight end, moves from right to left. Kaya looking to throw on a play action. Throws to the end zone. Lewis is there. And that is a touchdown. Malcolm Lewis pulls it in the far corner, and he gets 6 points on the board for Miami, and they're right back in the game.
He had man-to-man coverage out there on Daniel Davey. Just ran a little bit of a, I guess you'd call it a flag route. Ran up the field 10 yards, turned outside. Ball was on time. He had 1 foot in bounds. Touchdown.
Malcolm Lewis, first touchdown catch of the season. And it's now 24-20 with 5:09 to go. And here is Michael Badgley to try to make it a three-point game. Some fans over in that far corner were thinking that Lewis was bobbling a little bit. He did bobble, but I think he recovered in time to get his feet down. Kick is up and good. And so Miami cuts right back into Nebraska's lead with an impressive touchdown drive to get back to within 3 points in the game. Badgley to kick it away. Abdullah and Newby deep. 24-21 with 5:09 to go, third quarter. Here's the kick. Sailing right toward the goal line. Ameer gathers it in. He's to the 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, and not out of the 31-yard line. Good return by Ameer of 31 yards. Jamal Carter makes the Miami tackle, so the Huskers get it back. Up three, 5:02 left in the game, or third quarter. And Nebraska's offense has really been pounding away at this Miami defense. Nebraska scored at the end of the half on a long drive for a field goal, scored on their first drive of the third quarter with a touchdown. But now the lead back down to three. Pistol set, wing to the near side. Two wideouts to the near side. Hand it off to Ameer. Ameer cutting to the outside, 35, 40. He's got a first down off his, up to the 42-yard line. That's an 11-yard gain as Natambu Fentress knocks him down. But an 11-yard pickup for Abdullah, who's now over 160 in the game.
Alex Lewis with a good block at left tackle. Kenny Bell with a nice block in the alley there that really sprung him for the 11-yard gain.
Ball at the 42-yard line now. Amani Cross in there, trips to the far side. Shotgun look for Armstrong and Husker offense. Snap back, zone read, hand it off to Amani. Amani gets a couple to the 44-yard line. It'll be second down and eight. Tackle made by Cortell Jenkins for Miami. Second and eight from the Nebraska 44. Two backs, Newby and Cross on the hips of Armstrong. Zone read, hand off to Newby around the right edge to the 50. He's got a first down to the 47-yard line of Miami. So Newby running hard. Fentress knocks him down, but the Huskers pick up nine and a first down.
Great job by the wide receivers blocking out there. Westerkamp, Kenny Bell really locked onto their guys. Westerkamp made a great block.
So the Huskers moving into Miami territory at the 47-yard line with 3:45 to go in the third quarter. Trips to the near side, cross the one back in the backfield with Armstrong, who's in the shotgun. Here's a snap back to Tommy. Play action fake, looking to throw long down the field. Westerkamp, the pass is intercepted. Intercepted by Miami as the Hurricanes pick it off. It is Tracy Howard with his fifth career INT. Tommy's second pick of the year. I'm not quite sure where he was going with that, but Miami gets it at their own 28-yard line.
And they're trying to hit a wheel route with Westerkamp. Westy kind of stumbled coming out of it, but it looked to me like Tommy had decided where he was going to throw that ball before the snap. I haven't seen a replay yet, but that wasn't where he should have thrown it, because it had it been a good throw, Westerkamp would have gotten lit up.
Miami forces a huge turnover, and they'll have a chance to regain the lead when we pick up the action. But that does it for hour two of the show. We'll have Miami's drive and the rest of the game between the Huskers and the Hurricanes when Greatest Games rolls on next hour.
The Husker Sports Network from Learfield IMG College. You're listening to Sports.
I always wanted to do this. The mess, the noise. It's gonna be awesome.
Babe, what are you talking about? And what's with the sledgehammer?
I'm gonna demo the bathroom.
We chose Bathfitter to do the remodel, remember?
So?
With Bathfitter, there's no demolition or mess. They custom make our new bath and can install it in as little as one day.
No demo?
No demo.
Bathfitter's been exceeding expectations for 35 years, and we've got over 2 million satisfied customers to prove it. Visit bathfitter.com to learn more and book your free in-home consultation.
Presentation of Husker Sports, the best of Nebraska football's greatest games.
Kaya under center, Johnson behind him, turn, hand it off to Duke Johnson, and he fights forward for a first down. Ball pops out, it's picked up by Nebraska, this is a fumble, it's picked up by Josh Mitchell, 30, 20, Mitchell, 10, 5, touchdown Nebraska!
All
big plays, all the big names. With the voice of the Huskers, Greg Sharp.
Four down linemen for Nebraska to snap back. Little delay, hand off to Johnson. It's blown up. Malik Collins drills him at the 19-yard line. It's a loss of three. It's fourth down.
And color analyst Matt Davison.
What a hit. Malik Collins shoots through the line of scrimmage and drilled Johnson.
Now, here's the host of Husker Sports' Greatest Games, Josh Hilkeman.
And we begin Hour 3 of Greatest Games. I am Josh Hilkeman. Tonight we're taking you through the Nebraska-Miami matchup from September 20th, 2014. So far, we've made it through nearly three quarters of football at Memorial Stadium. The Huskers held a commanding 10-point lead just 5 minutes into the third quarter, but Miami pulled to within three on a Brad Kaya touchdown pass 5 minutes later. The momentum continued to turn the Canes' way with an interception by Tracy Howard on their own 28-yard line, and will resume play right there. In the meantime, head to Facebook and join Jeremiah Sirles as he hosts a live chat with former Huskers Ameer Abdullah, Kenny Bell, and Josh Mitchell. There's 3:32 on the clock, Miami's ball at their own 28, with Nebraska leading 24-21. Here again are Greg Sharp and Matt Davison.
Miami takes over at their own 28-yard line. 3:32 in the third, 24-21 Big Red. Duke Johnson back on the field. Two wideouts to the far side, one on the near side. Kaya in the shotgun, a wing to the far side. Snap back to Kaya, play action fake. He's back in the pocket, stepping back, throws a screen, throws it away, and there was nobody out there. A couple of linemen out there is where he threw it. He was still in the pocket. Now Duke Johnson got hung up a little bit. Both when he wants an intentional grounding. Duke Johnson gets kind of caught in here a little bit, but he's no end. Nebraska is grabbing him. A boatload of DBs out there for Nebraska. Kaya goes shotgun. Johnson to his right. Twins each way. From the Miami 28. Snap back to Kaya. Play action fake. Looking. Has time. Steps. Throws. Pass is caught by Berrios. Bumped out of bounds. With a first down in his back pocket at the 46-yard line. And there's all kinds of commotion back with Randy Gregory and Tanner Gavda, their right tackle. That play, though, goes for 18 yards of the first down for Miami Lane.
And Al Golden down, really getting in the ear of his right tackle, saying, you need to get back into the huddle, and you need to quit with the extracurricular. That was very, very lucky for Miami that a flag wasn't thrown on Gadboy.
First and 10, Miami. They convert on second and 10 with an 18-yard pass play. Trips to the near side. Kaya in the gun, turns, hands it off to Duke Johnson, slips a couple of tackles. Johnson to the outside, Banderas finally brings him down, but he picks up about 7 yards on the play. Banderas along with Cooper bring him down. He is really slippery to bring down.
He has a couple of missed tackles there.
Second and three coming up for Miami. Inside of 3 minutes left, third quarter, Huskers by three. Football now in Nebraska territory at the 47. Johnson stays in there.
Boy, do we need a guy to make a play, force a turnover, get a sack.
Kaya under center, Johnson behind him, turn, they hand it off to Duke Johnson, and he fights forward for a first down. Ball pops out, it's picked up by Nebraska, this is a fumble, it's picked up by Josh Mitchell, 30, 20, Mitchell, 10, 5, touchdown Nebraska!
And Greg, I think it was out. We just saw it again. I think the ball was out. He was falling to the ground. I couldn't see who knocked it out, but it came out by looking at it the first time. It looked like the ball was out before he hit the ground.
Boy, Miami wants this reviewed.
The prior play was a fumble. The play is under further review.
And the crowd just saw the replay themselves. The crowd knows what we just saw. That thing popped out before he was down. That scoop and score is going to stand.
And we're seeing it again. Trevor Roach gets in there, and Trevor Roach put his left hand on the football and ripped it out. What a play by Trevor Roach to get that thing out of there. And Josh Mitchell scooped it with nobody around him but red jerseys, and he takes it the other way. What a play.
The white hat just took the headset off. Here we go.
After further review, the ruling on the field is confirmed.
What a monster play in a big game where Nebraska was backed up a little bit. Looked like Miami was driving and a chance to take the lead. And those are momentum plays that change a football game.
Here's Drew Brown to try to add one more on the board. That was a 57-yard fumble recovery for Josh Mitchell for 6 points for Nebraska. Snap down, Brown's kick up and good. 31-21 Big Red. What a big play by Trevor Roach, who made a couple of huge hits a week ago at Fresno. He ripped that one out of there for Nebraska to get 6 points. Drew Brown with a low kick.
Oh, no.
He's going to hit at the 10 and go out of bounds. That'll be a penalty on Nebraska. So that will give Miami pretty good field position. The last scoop and score for Nebraska, Austin Cassidy up in Minnesota back in 2011. So it's been 3 years since Nebraska's had a fumble recovery return for a touchdown. Roach stays in there. Tuskers go nickel package. Roach and Santos on the field. First and 10, Miami at their own 35. Duke Johnson, who just fumbled, in the backfield with Brad Kaya, the true freshman quarterback. 31-21 NU. Snap back to Kaya. Gives it off to Duke Johnson. He gets hit, knocked down after a gain of two. Randy Gregory, David Santos make the tackle. It'll be second down and 8.
Gregory did a good job clamping down on that one. Lined up on the left side.
Second and 8. Miami a little bit slower moving right now. 2 minutes left in the quarter.
Be nice to have a three and out here because Nebraska just was out there on defense. You celebrate. Even the celebration takes a lot of energy. Now you're right back out there on defense.
Second and 8. Under centers Kaya. Stretch play. Fakes the handoff. Back to throw. Looking to go deep. Throws over the middle. Passes. Intercepted. Nate Gary at the 40. Flags come out. Gary to the 35. He's still on his feet down to the 34-yard line. Don't worry about the flag. It's a hold. Miami's piling on top of a Husker at the 26-yard line. Get that kid out of here.
Greg, there's going to be a flag before this. Randy Gregory at the end of the play is the guy on the bottom of the pile with Miami players all over him. But before that, there's another flag. Now you have coaches on the field.
Well, the flag came as a hold. The hold in the backfield. The interception's going to stand. Then what happens after the play might be offsetting, but the interception should stand.
The only thing that could – I didn't see if the quarterback got hit as he delivered it. The only thing that could go against Nebraska was if he was hit late. We hope it was a holding call, but maybe the quarterback was hit late.
Well, the officials are all talking. Lane, what do you have?
Well, this has been brewing all game long. Randy Gregory has been on the ground after almost every play with a Miami offensive lineman stepping on him, pushing him back down, putting his helmet back into the turf. The officials have warned them multiple times.
Stop. Roughing the passer defense.
Oh, roughing the passer.
15-yard penalty and a first down. Personal foul, dead ball defense. Personal foul, dead ball offense. The foul's offset. It will be Miami's ball, first and 10.
So there you go, roughing the passer.
Roughing the passer takes away the interception. And we have not seen a replay.
What a huge call in this game. Nebraska's about ready to put this thing away.
In this sort of a game, it better be blatant. If you're going to call roughing the passer, it had better be blatant. And I'll tell you what, this crowd is ramped up right now because Miami's got the ball back at midfield.
First and 10, Miami at the Nebraska 48. Kai in the shotgun gets the snap, sets, throws, pass caught. And it's a first down by Walford, the tight end, at the 33 of Nebraska, 15-yard pickup on the play. Gary, the late hit. Here, we're now going to get a look at this roughing the passer. Oh, my goodness. Are you kidding me? It was Vincent Valentine. Are you kidding me, Matt?
He was getting rid of the football. I don't know if they said he went at his knee or how you make that call.
Oh, my. We just saw the replay, folks. It is a horrible roughing the passer call. Right after Kaya let it go, Vincent Valentine was going into him at his knees.
Greg, it was almost a brawl in the middle of the football field. The officials didn't know what to do. They have big bodies being thrown all over the place. Greg McMullen took a Miami player, pulled him off the pile, and threw him out of there. Then you have coaches coming in from the sideline to make sure their players aren't throwing punches. I mean, this thing is nearly out of control.
Huskers have two linebackers out there in Roach and Zaire Anderson. A minute 13 left third quarter, Nebraska 31, Miami 21. Hand off to Duke Johnson, running around the edge. Huskers have it covered pretty well. Johnson go, fight for about 5. Brought down by Nate Gary. It'll be second down and 5. So the ball to 28, inside of a minute left. Wow.
Boy, is the intensity high in this one right now. You just hope there's not another fight. These players are just not happy with each other.
Kaya turns, looking to set up a screen, goes down the middle. The pass is caught inside the 10 for a first down by Standish DeBoard, a tight end for Miami, and they've got it first and goal after the pickup on the play of 23 yards. They'll actually mark it at the 8.
This young guy, Kaya, has really played well.
That was not bad coverage. He had to fit it into a tight sleeve. Jonathan Rose make the tackle. Miami does not have to snap before the end of the quarter. I think they may, though. There's still 12 seconds left. Kaya under center. First and goal at the 8. Gus Edwards, the deep back. Tight formation. turn. Stretch play left to Edwards, hit and drop. Great tackle by Santos at the 7. It'll be second and goal when we come back to begin the fourth quarter.
That's the end of the third quarter. We'll have the start of the fourth quarter after this timeout. Stay with us.
You're listening to Sports Nightly. This is the Husker Sports Network.
Valley 365 is here, and the time is now to take your farming technology full circle. Valley 365 is the ultimate command center, the new single sign-on platform that brings together our tried and true technology and streamlines your entire operation. Combining the best features of AgSense, Valley Scheduling, Valley VRI, and Valley Insights, Valley 365 is the next level solution for connected crop management. Leverage your data, make the most of your time, and own your tomorrow. Contact your Valley dealer today.
Fill up. To get to work. To camp. To grandma's. To the movies. To the skate park. To try the world's best tacos. To watch the sunset at Mount Rushmore. To ride on a green fiberglass dinosaur. Fill up your life. From the greatest monuments to those little moments, Sinclair is proud to fuel America's journeys. Go farther for less with DinoCare, Sinclair's top-tier engine cleaning gasoline. Learn more at SinclairOil.com.
Shop Woodhouse Ford and experience the Woodhouse difference. Ford Truck Month is going on now. Lease a 2019 Ranger Super Crew 4x4 XLT for $279 a month for 36 months. 7,500 miles a year, first payment, dock fee, and $1,500 down payment due at signing. Security deposit waived, tax title license extra. Come and visit us at one of our three convenient locations in Blair, Omaha, or Plattsmouth. Built Ford proud. WACTTL extra, lease for $279 per month, 36 months, 7,500 miles per year. First payment, dock fee, and $1,500 due at signing. Stock number T193631. Offer expires 03/31/2020. See dealer for details.
Making a quick trip to the store? You climb into the driver's seat. You start the car. The seatbelt indicator blinks and sounds. But you decide you don't need to use one. Think you are the only one that suffers if you don't wear your seatbelt? Think again, you're wrong. Family, friends, and coworkers suffer if you are killed or injured in a crash. Click it or ticket. Saving lives every day.
Make it click. NDOT Highway Safety Office. Fans, Nebraska Athletics has a new official app. Stay up to date with score alerts, live stats, live audio, roster schedules, and more by downloading the official app of the Huskers. Presented by Nebraska Crossing Outlets. Create your custom experience and stay on top of everything related to game day. With the ability to purchase tickets and merchandise, access the Husker Light Show, and concessions information, this app has everything a Husker fan needs. Download it in the Apple or Google Play Stores today.
Nebraska baseball, from grit to glory, tells the story of Will Bolt, starting from his playing days to his early coaching career and his eventual return to Nebraska. From Grit to Glory features interviews with former Nebraska baseball coach Darren Erstad, ESPN college baseball analyst Kyle Peterson, as well as Bolt's former teammates Jeff Lisey and Dan Johnson. Listen to this edition of our Husker Sports Network Originals, presented by JTech Construction.
This is the Husker Sports Network from Learfield IMG College. You're listening to Sports Nightly.
The Husker Sports Network is always on the air on Facebook and Twitter. Like the Husker Sports page on Facebook and follow at Husker Sports on Twitter. You'll get exclusive up-to-the-minute coverage of your Huskers, including live football practice reports, previews of what you'll hear on Sports Nightly that night, instant reaction and analysis on Husker news, and Nebraska Athletics coverage that you can't see or hear anywhere else. Follow the Husker Sports Network on Twitter and like the Husker Sports Network on Facebook today.
For nearly 50 years, Nottel Companies has carried on a tradition of bringing great developments to Husker Nation. As a commercial real estate developer, property manager, and investment company, we believe the community is our client. Visit some of our latest projects in Omaha, like Heartwood Preserve in the Builders District or River's Edge in Council Bluffs. Don't forget to check out the Inner Rail Food Hall, coming this fall to Exarban Village. For more information on our projects, visit nottlecompanies.com. Go Big Red!
Shop Woodhouse Chevy First in Missouri Valley, Iowa today and experience the Woodhouse difference. At Woodhouse, we make car buying simple and transparent. Take advantage of some of the best deals going on during Chevy Truck Month, like $11,000 off select Chevy Silverados. The Silverado is the perfect truck to get the job done. Find new roads and shop all of our inventory and offers at woodhousechevy.com. Or visit us at our dealership in Missouri Valley, Iowa today. This is Woodhouse. WEC, TT Electric, $100,000 off MSRP. $15,615. Stock number K200402 and K200388. Offer expires 3/31/2020. See dealer for details.
From the University of Nebraska-Lincoln, I'm journalism student Grace Fitzgibbon with Campus News. The cochlear implant program at UNL's Barclay Speech, Language, and Hearing Clinic is giving the gift of hearing. Spearheaded by Professor Josh Sevier, the program has completed more than a dozen cochlear implant activations over the past year. It's the first clinic to specialize in cochlear implants outside of the Omaha metro area, and Sevier plans to expand his efforts to reach patients in western Nebraska.
Chris Stapleton's All-American Roadshow. Saturday, October 17th, Pinnacle Bank Arena. With special guests, the Marcus King Band.
You wanna drink a water, got to go to the well.
And Yola.
Take a ride out in the country.
Tickets on sale now at Ticketmaster.com or the Ticketmaster app on your mobile device. Chris Stapleton's All-American Roadshow.
Fans, Nebraska Athletics has a new official app. Stay up to date with score alerts, live stats, live audio, rosters, schedules, and more by downloading the official app of the Huskers. Presented by Nebraska Crossing Outlets. Create your custom experience and stay on top of everything related to game day. With the ability to purchase tickets and merchandise, access the Husker Light Show, and concessions information, this app has everything a Husker fan needs. Download it in the Apple or Google Play Stores today.
The Sports Nightly Hotline is brought to you by Woodhouse Auto Family, bringing you more choices in brands, locations, and service. Experience the difference. Purchase with confidence. This is Woodhouse. Josh Hill coming back with you on a Friday night, the greatest games version of the show. We're playing back the Nebraska-Miami game from September 20th, 2014. And right now we're at the start of the fourth quarter. You still have time to head over to Facebook and join a live chat of the game featuring former Huskers Josh Mitchell, Ameer Abdullah, and Kenny Bell. And speaking of Mitchell, he just returned a fumble 57 yards for a touchdown to give his team a 31-21 advantage. We begin the fourth quarter with Miami threatening to get back into it. The Canes have the ball, second and goal at the Huskers 6. The Blackshirts, once again, looking to make a play.
So here we go, fourth quarter, second goal from Miami at the Nebraska 7. Under center is Kaya Edwards, the deep back. Play action fake, Kaya back, avoiding the rush, gets thrown down, Randy Gregory, first sack of the year, back at the 16-yard line. There's number 4. Welcome to the game, Randy.
What a big play, Randy, to come back after what happened 3 or 4 plays ago. And he jumped the cutter, guy tries to cut him, and he tackles him back at the 16-yard line.
All right, now third and goal from the 16, Huskers by 10, early fourth quarter. Nebraska shuffling personnel in. 3 wideouts to the far side, 1 to the near side. Kaya in the gun, Duke Johnson to his left. 4 down linemen for Nebraska to snap back. Little delay, handoff to Johnson, it's blown up. Malik Collins drills him at the 19-yard line. It's a loss of 3, it's fourth down.
What a hit. Malik Collins shoots through the line of scrimmage and drilled Johnson.
35-yard field goal attempt by the true freshman Badgley. Ball in the near hash. Snap is down. Badgley's kick sent into the uprights, and the kick is good. And Miami's back to within a score, 31-24. And Miami can thank the Zebras for that 3 points. That drive should not have happened. Badgley to kick it away. Badgley with a good end-over-end kick. Ameer comes up, makes a catch of the 2 in the near boundary. He's to the 10, trying to work his way to the middle of the field. He's to the 20, 25, knocked down at the 25-yard line. That's what the Huskers will start this drive. Jamal Carter makes the hit and stop. 13:30 left in the game. Nebraska 31, Miami 24. Huskers go shotgun look, trips to the far side. 1 wide out to the near side. Abdullah to the left of Armstrong. Snap back, puts it in the belly of Ameer. Plows forward across the 25, up to the 29-yard line. That's a gain of about 4 on first down. Tackle made by Pierre, one of the D tackles for Miami.
I think this is obviously a time where you ride number 8. He has 26 carries now, but 19 at half. Get him a lot of touches here in the fourth quarter. They have not been able to stop Abdullah yet tonight.
Second and 6 from the Nebraska 29. A wing to the near side, 2 wideouts to the far, 1 to the near. Armstrong on the shotgun. Tommy looking over the defense. Turns. Puts it in the belly of Ameer. Tommy keeps it. He's got a first down. 35, 40. First down up on the 43-yard line. Nice read by Tommy Armstrong. He goes for 14 yards and a Husker first down.
Yeah, he really rode Ameer from right to left across the formation. Really sold that give well. Got a good block on the right edge by Stephen Carter and then Kenny Bell down the field.
Huskers have it out at the 43-yard line. New set of downs with 12 and a half left in the game. Nebraska 31, Miami 24. Abdullah in the backfield with Tommy. Wing to the far side, 2 wideouts to the far side. Mark Pelini grabs the football, snaps it back, hand off to Ameer. Ameer fighting his way to the 45, and that's about it. Maybe to the 46 again at 3. Raphael Kirby, one of the backers for Miami, knocks him down. Pistol set, wide receivers left and right. Huskers with a double tight end set from their own 46. Stretch play to Abdullah off the right side. He's going to see him. He's at the 50. First down, 45, 40, 35. Cuts back, 30. Down to the 28-yard line is Ameer Abdullah. And with that carry, he's over 200 yards rushing in this game.
What a block on the right side by Sethan Carter. My goodness. Sterup just caved in the right side, and Sethan Carter rode his man to the sideline. There was a 10-yard gap over there for Ameer to run through.
First and 10, Huskers at the 28-yard line of Miami. Trips to the far side. Amani Cross now in the backfield with Tommy. Husker State with the tight end to the near side. Snap back. Zone read. Tommy keeps it himself around the left side. 25. Armstrong to the 23. Flag comes out late.
Going to get a hold on the wide receiver over there. I think it was maybe Kenny Bell or Jordan Westerkamp.
Holding offense number 71. Oh, 10-yard penalty. First down.
Alex Lewis.
I take that back. It was a good block out there by Westerkamp. And Alex got his third penalty of the night. That's a killer. That's a killer.
Two holds and an offsides. So that'll march Nebraska back 10 yards. 11:02 to go in the game. Huskers by 7. Have it first and 20 now at the Miami 38-yard line. Armstrong has Cross behind him. Now goes to the shotgun. Monty lines up right behind Sethan Carter. In motion's Terrell Newby. Tommy keeps it himself. He's got some running room. 35, 30. Tommy, 25. Down to the 22-yard line. Tommy Armstrong just went 16 yards. And the Huskers now have second and 4.
It's the second time Nebraska's run that play. They run motion left to right, and they run both running backs to the right side. And everybody just flows that way. And Tommy takes it back to the opposite side of the field, to the weak side of the formation. And there's nobody home for Miami.
Amani stays in there. It's a pistol set. Wing to the near side. Now they go shotgun. Two wide outs to the near side of the pattern. Snap back. Zone read. Tommy keeps it himself. Gets back to the line of scrimmage. Now third down and 4. Huskers are 6 of 8 in this game on third downs. Third and 4 coming up from the Miami 22. Ameer right behind Tommy. Now a shift to the shotgun. Two wide outs to the near side, one on the far side. Snap back. Tommy going to throw. Holds it. Looks. Throws over the middle. Pass dropped. And a flag comes out. Kenny Bell was the intended receiver. The flag came out from the line judge on the near boundary.
He might have had a hold.
Maybe on a
defensive
hold on
holding.
Westerkamp was tied up with one of the DBs, Antonio Crawford. This might be a defensive holding.
Oh, goodness. Would this be a big call? Is it an automatic first down?
Al Golden's about ready to. No, they say offensive interference. They're looking, talking to Al Golden. They're going to say it's on Westerkamp.
Pass interference, 84 offense. The penalty is declined. Fourth down.
Sam Cotton. Maybe they ran a pick play in the middle of the field and he ran into the guy. That's the only thing. I didn't see it happen, but I would assume they tried to run the shallow cross and pick him off with a tight end.
So here's Drew Brown. The ball will be close to the middle of the field. It's going to be a 39-yard attempt. Falconberry to snap it. Sam Fultz to put it down to try to give the Huskers a 10-point lead again with 9:26 to go in the game. Good snap. Ball down. Kick sailing toward the uprights, and the kick is good.
Off the upright.
It caromed off the upright end, and the Huskers do stretch their lead to 10 at 34-24.
It hit the left upright and bounced through. I could see after he kicked it, everybody in the end zone wasn't putting their hands up. They were questioning it. It went off the left upright and bounced in.
He had it in. His ball kind of has a draw to it, and it came back and hit that post, but then caromed in. That is a huge kick by Drew Brown. Huskers extend that lead to 10 here with just 9:21 left to go in the game.
The Huskers make it a two-score game once again on the Drew Brown field goal. 34-24 Nebraska with 9:21 to go in the contest. We'll continue along with Miami's drive after the break.
You're listening to Sports Nightly. This is the Husker Sports Network.
It's your month, America, because this is Ford Truck Month. Your month for great deals on legendary Ford trucks like F-150, Super Duty, and Ranger. Your month to drive Ford F-Series, America's best-selling trucks 43 years straight. Your month for big-time power, off-road capability, and turning heads around town. Your month to, well, you get the idea.
Based on 1977 through 2019 calendar year total sales.
Great deals, tough trucks. Oh, yeah. It's Ford Truck Month, all right.
You always dreamed of owning your own farm. Now you're living your dream, and it's time to pick the tractor that makes it all come together. Massey Ferguson has reinvented what compact and utility tractors can be and redefined what they do, making them easier to operate, more comfortable to drive, more versatile than ever. Massey Ferguson gives Nebraska farmers the power and performance to win in the field.
Butte Implement Company of Butte.
There's no community like a Cenex community, and that's why every Cenex store is so proud to serve theirs by supporting local athletic teams, promoting the arts, and making sure each store is a place its neighbors can find what they need, catch up with their friends, and stay connected. It's also why we give back, helping to make the wonderful places we call home the best they can be. Your local Cenex doesn't just work in your town, it lives there. The store next door, powered locally at Cenex.
Valley 365 is here, and the time is now to take your farming technology full circle. Valley 365 is the ultimate command center, the new single sign-on platform that brings together our tried and true technology and streamlines your entire operation. Combining the best features of AgSense, Valley Scheduling, Valley VRI, and Valley Insights, Valley 365 is the next level solution for connected crop management. Leverage your data, make the most of your time, and own your tomorrow. Contact your Valley dealer today.
Fill up. To get to work. To camp. To grandma's. To the movies. To the skate park. To try the world's best tacos. To watch the sunset at Mount Rushmore. To ride on a green fiberglass dinosaur. Fill up your life. From the greatest monuments to those little moments, Sinclair is proud to fuel America's journeys. Go farther for less with DinoCare, Sinclair's top-tier engine cleaning gasoline. Learn more at SinclairOil.com.
Hey, Husker Nation, this is former Pipeline member Brendan Stye here to tell you Bill Moose was right when he said,
Nebraska needs to get back to being Nebraska.
And you can help us get there. Go big and be a part of the future home of Nebraska football. This project will once again establish Nebraska as the standard for growth and commitment to student athletes, and we need your help to make it happen. Contact the Huskers Athletic Fund office or visit HuskersAthleticFund.com to find out how you can contribute. Go Big Red.
This is the Husker Sports Network from Learfield IMG College. You're listening to Sports Nightly.
Your journey starts now. Arrow Stage Lines is now accepting applications for CDL drivers across all locations. This is not just a driving job. This is an adventure. At Arrow Stage Lines, you get paid to experience scenic destinations, sporting events, historical landmarks, and so much more. Drive some of the latest pristine equipment on the road with superior safety ratings, excellent benefits, and so much more. Start your journey today at Arrow Stage Lines. Apply at drivearrow.com.
I always wanted to do this. The mess, the noise, it's gonna be awesome.
Babe, what are you talking about? And what's with the sledgehammer?
I'm gonna demo the bathroom.
We chose Bathfitter to do the remodel, remember?
So?
With Bathfitter, there's no demolition or mess. They custom make our new bath and can install it in as little as one day.
No demo?
No demo.
Bathfitter's been exceeding expectations for 35 years, and we've got over 2 million satisfied customers to prove it. Visit bathfitter.com to learn more and book your free in-home consultation.
For nearly 50 years, Nottel Companies has carried on a tradition of bringing great developments to Husker Nation. As a commercial real estate developer, property manager, and investment company, we believe the community is our client. Visit some of our latest projects in Omaha, like Heartwood Preserve in the Builders District, or River's Edge in Council Bluffs. Don't forget to check out the Inner Rail Food Hall, coming this fall to Exarban Village. For more information on our projects, visit NottleCompanies.com. Go Big Red!
Hey, how's Marie?
Surprisingly well. We got her to Nebraska Medicine right away, and they removed the clot causing her stroke within minutes.
Minutes? Really?
Whether it's something serious, or if you simply want to feel your best, start with the Nebraska Medicine Health Network. This is where world-leading specialists offer leading-edge services you won't find anywhere else in the state. Like Nebraska's only comprehensive stroke center and CAR T-cell therapy, the latest cancer breakthrough. We also offer innovative clinical trials and perform the most research in Nebraska. It all adds up to the state's most comprehensive care. So you have every advantage possible, close to home.
So she's all good? No problems from the stroke?
Oh yeah, perfectly fine. I mean, you can't even tell that she just went through something really serious.
Wow, amazing.
To schedule an appointment today, visit NebraskaMed.com. Nebraska Medicine. Serious medicine, extraordinary care.
Over 6 million Americans meet the criteria for gambling addiction, and many more are affected by gambling problems. Problem gambling is a serious condition. With help, problem gamblers can improve their lives. If you or someone you love has a gambling problem, call Choices Treatment Center at 402-476-2300 or the Nebraska Gamblers Assistance Program at 1-833-238-6837. Help is free, so call today.
Nebraska baseball, from grit to glory, tells the story of Will Bolt from his playing days to his return to Nebraska as head coach. Subscribe to Husker Sports Podcasts on any streaming service to listen to the newest Husker Sports original presented by JTech Construction. Welcome back to Greatest Games. I'm Josh Hilkeman. Let's get you right back to the action. The Huskers have the lead on Miami, 34-24, with 9:21 remaining in the contest. Here's Greg Sharp and Matt Davison with the call on the ensuing kickoff.
And now Drew Brown will kick it off. Now you don't want him to kick it out of bounds again. Remember, his last one went out of bounds. It gave Miami a really good field position. Dorsett, Coley deep for the Canes. Brown's approach and kick. He gets into this one pretty good. Coley, a couple of yards deep, is coming out. Now he bottles it, and he'll go to a knee. So Miami will have it at the 25-yard line. Josh Mitchell back on the field for Nebraska. Snap back to Kaya. Little wide receiver screen to Lewis out in the flat. Lewis racing to the 25, bumped out of bounds to the 27, only gained him about two. He was hammered out of bounds by Corey Cooper. It'll be second down and eight.
Santos took a great angle there. He has played the game of his career tonight.
Second and eight. Kaya in the gun, Johnson to his left. Trips to the far side, one wide out to the near side. Huskers with only three down linemen. Snap back. Kaya has time. Deep fade route looking down on the near boundary. The pass is caught by Dorsett. What a grab. Top of the head of Daniel Davey. A good coverage at the Nebraska 41-yard line. Boy, that's a terrific throw and a better catch.
I think he caught it behind on the back of Daniel Davey. Davey had good coverage, and he just kind of took it off of his shoulder for a big gainer. Nebraska brought a blitz and went man-to-man on the outside. They took a shot over the top and converted.
That's Dorsett's first catch of the night. He burned Arkansas State a week ago. Four wideouts in the pattern, two each way. Kaya in the shotgun with Johnson to his right. Turns, throws it out in a flat pass. Caught by Barrows. There's Daniel Davey to blow it up. It's a loss of three. Daniel Davey, terrific job reading that play. It'll be second and 13.
Davey's a big corner out there. Physical guy. Sniffed that one out quickly. Was able to come up and make the play. We've talked so much about missed tackles here tonight. He didn't miss that one.
Huskers changing personnel again. Trips to the far side. Empty backfield. Huskers have their base set out there. Not sure this is what Nebraska wants. Snap back to Kaya. A little wide receiver screen out to Johnson. Dukes get it to down to the 35. He gains eight. It sets up third down and three coming up. Tackle made by Vincent Valentine.
Vince is down. I think he's going to need a blow here. Great job pursuing the play. He's a big fella. Came a long ways to make that play.
Holding his left leg a little bit. They're going to go empty back. Nope, they'll go under center with Kaya. Johnson behind him. Rolling the pocket is Kaya. Looking to throw. Throws it deep downfield. Passes incomplete. Threw it behind his intended receiver.
Oh, goodness.
Berrios. Did he throw interference on that?
He threw an interference call. Then the official fell down as he's running in to make the call. That ball was so poorly thrown.
How is that interference?
I don't think you can make that call.
There's no way. Cockrell had terrific coverage. The ball was thrown behind Berrios, who slid to a stop.
No foul for
yes.
Defensive pass interference.
Thank you. There might have been a riot in Lincoln if they called that thing.
Now it's probably four down territory here. A 52-yard field goal.
Yeah, they're outside the thing. So here we go. Fourth and four, 7:24 left, 34-24, Big Red. The offense stays on the field for Miami. Nebraska trying to match personnel. Will go with their dime package as Joshua Kalu comes in. Two wideouts to the far side, two to the near side. Duke Johnson in the backfield with Brad Kaya. Fourth and four from the Nebraska 35. Snap back to Kaya. Whistle blows. Timeout taken, I believe, by Nebraska. Yes, Huskers use their first timeout in the fourth quarter to line up for this fourth down play. They are going for it. Kaya will be in the shotgun. Two wideouts each way. Duke Johnson to his right. Huskers will go with three down linemen. Yep, Randy's going to stand up on the edge. Snap back to Kaya. Looking, holding, throws downfield, pass intercepted, picked off. Huskers intercept the pass. It is Joshua Kalu with the pick. Huskers will take over on downs, and there's more friction at the end of the play. Randy Gregory, now Randy shoves a guy. It was Taylor.
Oh, boy.
Now we've got almost a riot. Now Huskers are running off the bench. Nebraska's got to stay on their bench. Here it's right in front of the Miami bench. But Kalu with the pick to stop that drive by Miami.
After the play was over, dead ball, personal foul, Miami number 62. Dead ball, personal foul, Miami number 76. Both fouls will be enforced. It'll be Nebraska's ball, first down.
So that'll be 30 yards of penalties after the pick by Kalu.
And listen to this crowd.
And Nebraska's going to have it in Miami territory and a chance to really pop a hole in this game with 7:18 left.
I'll tell you, Greg, since you start playing sports when you're a little kid and you go play in high school and you play in college, or it doesn't matter where you're playing, there's nobody that's more fun to beat than a team that's kind of dirty, a team that talks a lot. And that's what we're getting tonight.
Huskers first and 10 at the 40 of Miami. Hand off to Ameer Abdullah. He blasts around the right side. Oh, he gets collared. Oh, my goodness. A big time face mask on Ameer Abdullah. That young man needs to be ejected from this game. That's a 3-yard gain. That is dirty, dirty, dirty.
Personal foul, face mask, defense number 17. 15-yard penalty, first down.
That's the worst face mask I've seen in years in football. That could have really hurt Ameer Abdullah. That could have really hurt Ameer Abdullah.
Twins to the far side. Abdullah right behind Armstrong. Snap back. Stretch play, Ameer. Right side to the 20. Knocked out of the 19. Again, a 3. It'll be 2nd and 7.
And, Greg, I just saw the play again. I'm not even sure he had his hand on the face mask. It was around his neck and almost had him around the chin strap area on the bottom side of the helmet when he ripped him down.
Ameer with a career high in attempts. He's over 200 yards rushing in the game, and he barely has his head still tied on. Turn. Hand off to Ameer. He's at a 15, down to the 14-yard line. Again, of about 5 more. It'll be 3rd and 2 coming up. Tackle made by Gunter, the corner on the near side.
What a workhorse he's been tonight. He wants that one back. He thinks he should have scored.
32nd carry of the game right there for Ameer Abdullah. Now 3rd down and about 2 for the Huskers. Up 34-24 with 5:52 left in the game.
And all night, Greg, every time Ameer Abdullah has been tackled tonight, he's gotten up and he's hit the Miami defender on the head or on the rear saying, good tackle. Just a good kid.
Armstrong in the shotgun, turns. Hands it off to Ameer. He's got a 1st down of the 9. It'll be 1st and goal, Huskers of the 9. Tackle made by Pierre, the defensive tackle.
This is where you jam it down their throat, right into the end zone. Go up by 17, put this thing away, and put them on an airplane.
Ameer now with 215 on the ground. Well, he's over 200 yards rushing twice this season now. Remember, he had the big game against FAU week 1. 1st and goal at the 9.
Now ball security is number 1. Ball security.
5:08 left in the game. Cotton, the wing to the near side. Tommy lets the play clock get inside of 5. Claps his hands. Stretch play right to Abdullah. Ameer gets caught again. Knocked down to the 5-yard line. Gain of 4 more. And that looked like another face mask.
Well, that's what the crowd wanted. I don't think he grabbed the face mask. It was just another high tackle. You know, Ameer has such good ball, pad level.
Yeah, I don't know that it was. 2nd and goal from the 5. 4.5 left. Nebraska 34, Miami 24. Boy, this is one dirty bunch from Miami. And yet Nebraska got the roughing the passing call. Go figure. 2nd and goal for the 5. Armstrong and a gun. Snap back. Miami jumps the gun. It's a legal procedure on the Hurricanes. That'll be half the distance.
If Miami
infraction, offense number 56.
Oh.
5-yard penalty. 2nd down.
Kind of faked the snap.
He did. It was on Mark Pulini, so that backs Nebraska up to the 10. 7th penalty of the game on the Big Red.
Tell you what, if Miami gets the ball back here in the last couple minutes, every play there's going to be something brewing, and you just have to keep your head. I know that there's a lot of emotion, but you can't do anything that takes you out of the next ball game.
2nd and goal from the 10. Pistol set. Abdullah behind Armstrong. Wide receivers left and right. Stretch play right to Abdullah. He gets inside a 5. Ameer Abdullah, touchdown, Nebraska. Huskers stick 6 more in the end zone.
How you deal with a bully. Back them down, drive it down the field, stick it in the end zone, and you represent your school the right way like Ameer Abdullah does with such class after scoring that touchdown.
40-24 Nebraska. Drew Brown to try to give the Huskers a 17-point lead. Snap down, a kick is up, and a kick is good.
An insurance score there for the Huskers as Ameer Abdullah caps an amazing game on that 10-yard run. 4 minutes to go in the contest, Nebraska with a 17-point edge over the Hurricanes. While the conclusion of the game and wrap up the show right after this.
You're listening to Sports Nightly. This is the Husker Sports Network.
Valley 365 is here, and the time is now to take your farming technology full circle. Valley 365 is the ultimate command center, the new single sign-on platform that brings together our tried and true technology and streamlines your entire operation. Combining the best features of AgSense, Valley Scheduling, Valley VRI, and Valley Insights, Valley 365 is the next-level solution for connected crop management. Leverage your data, make the most of your time, and own your tomorrow. Contact your Valley dealer today.
Why choose between the technology you need and the seed company you prefer? With Rob Seco, you don't have to. Our independence lets us bring you the trait technology you need, like the Enlist E3 and the Liberty Link GT27 systems, AgriSure Duracade, AgriSure Viptera, AgriSure Artesian, and more. So you have the independence to plant what you want. The technology you need from the people you trust. Rob Seco. Visit RobSeco.com to find a representative near you.
It's your month, America, because this is Ford Truck Month. Your month for great deals on legendary Ford trucks like F-150, Super Duty, and Ranger. Your month to drive Ford F-Series, America's best-selling trucks 43 years straight. Your month for big-time power, off-road capability, and turning heads around town. Your month to, well, you get the idea.
Based on 1977 through 2019 calendar year total sales.
Great deals, tough trucks. Oh yeah, it's Ford Truck Month, all right.
Fill up, to get to work, to camp, to grandma's, to the movies, to the skate park, to try the world's best tacos, to watch the sunset at Mount Rushmore, to ride on a green fiberglass dinosaur. Fill up your life. From the greatest monuments to those little moments, Sinclair is proud to fuel America's journeys. Go farther for less with DinoCare, Sinclair's top-tier engine cleaning gasoline. Learn more at SinclairOil.com.
This is the Husker Sports Network from Learfield IMG College. You're listening to Sports Nightly.
When I hired Bathfitter, I got a new bathtub that I love. It's made with the same quality materials they used in luxury hotels. It's great. Even my mom thinks so.
I love your new tub, sweetie.
Trouble is, when she visits, she thinks she's staying in a 5-star hotel.
Could I get fresh towels?
Yes, Mom. Mom.
From luxury hotels to homeowners, Bathfitter exceeds expectations. Transform your bathroom in as little as one day. Visit bathfitter.com to learn more and book your free in-home consultation.
Your journey starts now. Arrow Stage Lines is now accepting applications for CDL drivers across all locations. This is not just a driving job. This is an adventure. At Arrow Stage Lines, you get paid to experience scenic destinations, sporting events, historical landmarks, and so much more. Drive some of the latest pristine equipment on the road with superior safety ratings, excellent benefits, and so much more. Start your journey today at Arrow Stage Lines. Apply at drivearrow.com.
The Sports Nightly Hotline is brought to you by Woodhouse Auto Family. Bringing you more choices and brands, locations, and service, experience the difference. Purchase with confidence. This is Woodhouse. Back one final time tonight on Greatest Games as Nebraska holds a commanding 41-24 advantage over the Miami Hurricanes. There's still a couple minutes left in our live discussion on Facebook with Jeremiah Sirles, Kenny Bell, Ameer Abdullah, and Josh Mitchell, so get there now as we get you back to Memorial Stadium for the end of the contest.
Drew Brown's kickoff, a short kick bobbled by Miami, picked up. At about the 20 by Dorsett, he goes down at the 22-yard line. That's where Miami will have it. 4:07 left. Huskers lead it 41-24. Ball to 21, Kaya in the shotgun. Four wideouts, two each way. Back to throw is Kaya. Holding, looking, throws to the near boundary. Underthrows the intended receiver. Barrios on the coverage was Cockrell. It'll be second down and 10. Snap back. A little handoff to Duke Johnson, trying to get to the outside. He does. First down across the 30. Knocked down by Nate Gary. Or actually, Trevor Roach knocked him down at the 36. That'll be a gain of 15. And a first down for Miami with 3:53 left to go in the game. Joe Yearby in there right now, a true freshman tailback. Kaya has two wideouts each way. Back to throw is Kaya. Throws, batted down. Greg McMullen knocked that ball down. Marcus Newby was out there. I don't know that Marcus has been out there a lot tonight. He was coming off the edge hard that time. Second and 10. Kaya has Yearby off to his left. Trips to the far side. Back to throw is Kaya. Throws over the middle. Pass wide open. Making the catch is Dorsett into Nebraska territory. Down to the 47-yard line. Zaire Anderson makes the tackle after the 17-yard gain. We're going to be under 3 minutes before the next snap. Trips to the far side. One on the near side. Yearby off to the left of Kaya. Back to throw is Kaya. Gets hit as he throws.
Randy.
It's a ball loose in the backfield. That's a live football. Malik Collins diving for it as the ball squirted backwards, and it's picked up by Miami. Dorsett raced there and beat Collins to the ball at the 38-yard line.
I don't know why Malik didn't think it was a live ball.
He did it.
He should have been on it, but there was no whistle. He should have jumped on it. Dorsett ran right past him and jumped on the football. Randy Gregory knocked it away as Kaya was getting ready to throw the ball, but they're going to say it was a fumble and not that his arm was going forward.
This might get overturned because we have a Barbasol replay right now. They may say he was, but his arm was going backwards. I mean, he's throwing to the side.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands.
So the 15-yard loss will stand up. Miami's looking at second and 25 from their own 38-yard line. Kaya has Yearby in the backfield with him. Two wideouts each way. Snap back. Kaya has it. Holds. Throws over the middle. Ball caught at midfield by Yearby. And he's down to the Nebraska 40-yard line. Tackled by Trevor Roach. But they got a chunk of that back. It'll be now third down and three coming up. A 22-yard pickup.
Tough play there for Trevor Roach. Out of the backfield. They just run everybody else deep down the field. And he's one-on-one with the eye back.
Third and three from the Nebraska 40. A minute 45 left in the game. Huskers 41. Hurricanes 24. Kaya in the gun. Yearby to his right. Snap back. They roll the pocket right. Kaya looks, throws deep downfield. He overthrows the intended receiver. It'll be fourth down coming up. Fourth down and three for the Nebraska 40. Kaya in the gun. Trips to the far side. One to the near side. Kaya back to throw. Throws right. Pass caught. First down. Pulled in by the tight end, Walford. He's a good player. Really impressed with Walford, a 6'4 senior. First down at the Nebraska 32. Clock moving again. A minute 20 left in the game.
Yeah, Oscar's he's one place. Of those really athletic tight ends. You know, really tough cover for anybody that's a linebacker. If you put a smaller guy on him, he's too big.
Trips to the near side. Kaya gets the snap. Looks over the middle. Throws down the middle. Pass caught again by Walford, the tight end at the 11. Knocked down by Corey Cooper. So now it's first and 10 at the 11 with a minute 7 left to go. 20-yard pickup. Clock moving. 55 seconds left. 10th play of the drive. Trips to the near side. Kaya gets the snap, looks right, looks over the flat. Pass is caught. Slipping the tackle is Johnson, and he is in touchdown.
Three tackles, I think, were missed there.
So Duke Johnson slides by a couple more Huskers and gets in.
After further review, when the runner's knee was down, the ball was at the one-yard line. The ball be placed at the one-yard line, first and goal.
So it was enough for a first down, so they'll have a new set of downs at the one. 43 seconds left. Miami does have all three timeouts left if Al Golden chooses to extend this game. Duke Johnson will be in the backfield. So take the touchdown off. It's back to a 41-24 game with the ball at the one.
They ran a toss sweep the last time they brought in the big package.
Under center is Kaya. Johnson the eye. Wing to the near side. Toss sweep right to Johnson. Trying to get around the edge. Gets hit. Drop. He did not get in. Clock rolling. 35 seconds left. And Al Golden, I think, is going to call a timeout. Yep, he did. So Al Golden will use a timeout with 32 seconds left. Second and goal. Ball between the two and the one. Miami will stay with the I formation. Kaya under center. Johnson the deep back.
For somebody out in the flat on play action.
Wofford the tight end in motion. Keep an eye on that young guy. Play action fake. Kaya looking to throw. Throws it in the flat. Overthrows everybody. It's third down. Trying to hit the board. The other tight end of the near boundary. I would have gone to the other guy. Walford is really good, but they met him in motion. 27 seconds left. 41-24 NU. Walford again in motion to the right side. Turn. Hand it off to Johnson. Hit the backfield. Goes down at the 4-yard line. Nebraska stuffs it. Al Golden will call another timeout with 22 seconds left to go.
Miami.
Terrific play made by Malik Collins.
Randy Gregory took his guy and threw him in the backfield, too. Malik Collins has played a great football game. Kevin Maurice right in the middle of the thing and pushed his man into the backfield.
Huskers come back in on defense. I don't think anybody's left. This is great. Kyle will go shotgun this time.
From the 4-yard line.
Duke Johnson to his right. Tight formation. Four wideouts all tight to the line of scrimmage. Man in motion's Berrios. Snap back to Kaya. Here comes the rush. Throws in a flat pass. Caught, touchdown, Miami. Berrios rolled out and scores with 18 seconds left in the game. Badgley to kick. Up and good. 41-31 with 18 left.
Now let's not kick an onside kick here and have, oh boy, now after the play again, the officials have to come in. That was no big deal. Just a small exchanging words.
Badgley kicks and
was touched early.
Flags come out. I think Miami was offsides. I think they got the ball, actually.
I think they were offsides, and I think they touched the ball before it went 10 yards as well. So it should be Nebraska ball either way.
Illegal touching. All right, this should be a one-snap kneel down. Huskers in the victory formation. This has been a gritty effort tonight. 17-14 at the half. Huskers are going to win it 41-31 in a game that was on the fence of losing total control at several different times. I'm still really amazed that nobody has been ejected from this game tonight. A lot of personal fouls, a lot of bad blood, and you're kind of wondering how come. I mean, these teams haven't played in 13 years, but Miami came with a chip on their shoulder tonight. Snap, Armstrong goes down, that'll do it. And on a night where the 1994 Huskers were honored, Nebraska wins their 400th game in this venue.
Most of the Husker fans that stay in the South Stadium are clapping for Miami as they leave the field. Always classy to do that for a team that comes in, win or lose.
So, it's in the books. Nebraska 4-0 on the year. The two number eights embracing in the middle of the field as well. Duke Johnson's a heck of a football player.
Yeah, Duke Johnson and Ameer Abdullah, two great running backs, and they're talking right now in the middle of the field. That's good to see. Ameer is going to have the respect of these guys on defense. As I said, he got tackled tonight 35, well, not 35 times. He scored a couple times, but every time he got tackled, he'd get up and he'd pat them on the helmet or on the back, say, great tackle. So you're not going to hear anything bad about Ameer Abdullah. I just hope the post game, you know, doesn't get too crazy with the questions, and I hope the guys use their heads.
Feels good. Huskers 4-0.
41-31, the final score. Nebraska with a big win over the Hurricanes to improve to 4-0 on the 2014 season. Ameer Abdullah led the way for the Huskers with 229 yards rushing and two touchdowns on the ground. He also caught one pass for a score. Defensively, the Blackshirts came up with a number of big plays. David Santos and Joshua Clue each had an interception, and Josh Mitchell had one of the biggest plays up.